following is a special presentation of Raycom Sports, home to regional college football and basketball.
Lights up when the Jackets are at home. Georgia Tech faces a get-it-together game against a difficult but determined non-conference rival. Live from Grant Field at Bobby Dodd Stadium in Atlanta, Raycom Sports presents ACC football, a non-conference clash. Mississippi State from the SEC taking on the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets. Ironically enough, these two schools were in the same conference for 30 years, but never met. In fact, today's game is only the third meeting between the two. They last met in 1929. I'm Steve Martin. Good afternoon and welcome to Atlanta. And along with me, Rick Doc Walker. Doc, we weren't at that game. We were on another assignment in 1929.
We wanted to be there.
We wanted to. But if we'd been there and translated into today's action, we're going to see an outstanding defensive team in Mississippi State, maybe the likes of which we haven't seen in the ACC yet.
Yeah, well, when you hold Auburn, you look at a 3-2 ball game against the Auburn Tigers, and this group is athletic. They get off blocks if you can get to them. They swarm to the ball, and it's really something I'm looking forward to seeing. I mean, how often do you find a unit that is this well? Yeah, we have great players, but this is a unit that is outstanding.
Well, of course, you talk about units that surprise. Georgia Tech fits that category as well, as they've executed Paul Johnson's offense, and he's getting great play out of quarterback Josh Nesmith.
Yeah, and to run this, you have to have a quarterback who's not only smart, but the guy's got to be gutsy, athletic, and Nesmith is really, he's averaging close to 5 yards per carry. We've seen him with the inside run, the fake. He can get around the corner, and the thing I like about him most, he's highly competitive.
151 yards rushing as a quarterback against Virginia Tech. That set a school record. 5 for 8, 190 yards in the air, 109 yards in the air. Not an awful lot of passes for this Georgia Tech team. They might want to put it up a little bit more today. Well, Doc, let's take a look at our Toyota keys to the game. And for Mississippi State, they've got to really move the chains. Only 6 first downs against Auburn last week.
Yeah, if you look at, they went through a stretch of 0-14 on third down. So that means they've got to be really good on first and second down. They can't afford to get in third and long. And I think they've made a commitment to run the ball between the tackles today.
Georgia Tech's got to make a commitment to hang on to the football this afternoon.
Absolutely. And, you know, contrary to what you may think, it's not like you're fumbling a lot within this offense. They've been judicious in that. But what they've got to do is make sure it doesn't get on the ball in any area, because they need possession. That'll also keep Mississippi State off the field.
Well, the fact that Georgia Tech is ahead of schedule by the fans' estimation doesn't make Paul Johnson any happier. He wants to see results. And in a non-conference game with Mississippi State, they could be big today. This is a Mississippi State football team that is great defensively, adequate offensively. We'll see how it all shakes out. We'll come back. Mike Hogwood brings us back to Grant Field and Bobby Dodd Stadium right after this. The trophy case that includes a trophy for a national championship. And there's the Ramblin' Wreck. And it celebrates and heralds the arrival of the Georgia Tech football team. And it'll have the Georgia Tech fans up on their feet. We've got a good contingent from Mississippi State. The Ramblin' Wreck is on the move. Here come the Yellow Jackets at 2-1 off a narrow loss to Virginia Tech a week ago as they come out in a key non-conference encounter against Mississippi State. Only the third matchup between these two Southern schools. And now let's head to the sidelines. The third member of our broadcast team talking about the Yellow Jackets defense. Here's Mike Hogwood.
Yeah, first I got to get out of the way of the wreck of these players coming down here. But the defense is going to be important on both sides, Steve. You're exactly right. Mississippi State played great against Auburn. But Georgia Tech's defense has really risen up this season. Over the last 12 quarters, five of them have been shutouts. Their pass defense ranked second in the ACC. And up front, they may have the best front four in the ACC. Three of the four there are seniors. So that Georgia Tech defense is going to be tough. The Bulldogs are out on the field. That means we're ready to play some football. Kickoff, Georgia Tech, Mississippi State, straight ahead.
ACC football is presented in high definition where available by MFS Investment Management, a diverse range of products so advisors can choose what fits. Good afternoon, everybody, and there is the guy right there who won SEC Coach of the Year honors in 2007. What a marvelous job Sylvester Froome has done rebuilding the Mississippi State football program. He's in his fifth season, took them to a bowl game last year, the Liberty Bowl, where they won for Central Florida. And there's Paul Johnson, first year in the ACC, but an impressive resume otherwise as far as what he did at Georgia Southern, and five straight bowl bids at Navy, an outstanding record, 109 wins and 40 losses. Last meeting, 1929, 2 weeks before the stock market crash. I don't know if this week has any juxtaposition with that date. Georgia Tech won it 27-13. But they never played as members of the SEC.
Your memory is astounding. Yeah. It really is.
I was asleep during that time. All right, Adam Carlson's going to kick it off as Mississippi State won the toss but deferred. We have a beautiful day weather-wise, just barely close to 70 degrees. Jonathan Dwyer getting ready, along with Tyler Melton, to receive the kick of that man, Adam Carlson. And we are underway. This is Dwyer at the five. And Dwyer is met by Washington at the 21-yard line. Let's take a look at the Georgia Tech offense. Lucas Cox, the running back, or A-back, if you will. Jonathan Dwyer, the B-back, and Roddy Jones caught a touchdown pass last week. Tyler Melton, Demarius Thomas, all the wide receivers and backs up front. Andrew Gardner leads the way. He is a preseason All-ACC pick with Howard, Voss, Gilbert, and Brown. There's your Georgia Tech starting offensive unit. And of course, they're brought out at quarterback by Josh Nesbitt on first and 10 at the 21. And we've got a stoppage here. We have an SEC crew working today's game, led by Hubert Owens. And the clock did not start when the ball was possessed by Jonathan Dwyer, so they've got to take an arbitrary judgment as to where this clock sits. This is probably the most difficult thing, I think. There are many difficult things that officiating crews do, but when they have to estimate what's left on the clock, and now they're ready to go.
And you say, well, what's the importance of this early? Everything. Because when it gets late, those seconds could determine winning or losing.
Both of these schools have been in that situation last week. They both were in tight battles and lost at the end in the fourth quarter, where they could have used three or four more seconds. This is Roddy Jones. Gets the pitch and tries the left side. And he gets up to the 24-yard line. It'll be a gain of two. K.J. Wright in on the tackle. Let's take a look at the Mississippi State defense. It's a good one. Or Nesbitt. Josh Nesbitt, of course, the quarterback for the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets. We'll cite him first. He's the sophomore out of Greensboro, Georgia. Last week, rushed for 151 yards on a very good Virginia Tech defense, and that's a school record for a quarterback at Georgia Tech. Second down. Second and seven, first man through. And Dwyer carries up over the 25, and he'll make that to the 26, a gain of two. Let's look at him defensively. Jesse Bowman, SEC offense, defensive lineman of the week. Charles Burns and Tim Bailey at the ends. Cortez McCraney is the defensive tackle. The linebackers, an impressive group with some adjustments made. Dominique Douglas, Terrell Johnson is the starter this week. Douglas moves into the middle, and K.J. Wright in the inside, and Derek Pegues leads a talented secondary. It's third down and four. First possession of the ball game. Nesbitt to the corner. Good block there by Roddy Jones, and he's out of bounds at the 34-yard line. and he's going to get the first down. Damon Glanton, fifth-year senior, comes up with a tackle.
Well, Glanton's nice. So far, Mississippi State hadn't given up anything. You talk about stingy on the edge, but this is what makes Georgia Tech potentially out of sight, because they'll take your best shot and then break you down on one play.
You look at Dan Voss, who comes out over center for the Yellow Jackets. 2-1 coming into this game. Big road win at Boston College. They won against Jacksonville State here on a Thursday night to open the season. Here's Dwyer. Not much there. Pursued and hauled down. Keith Fitzhugh, senior from Hampton, Georgia, playing really in his own backyard here. Mississippi State has 14 players from the state of Georgia.
I'll tell you what they do, man. This is fun to watch them. Watch this side over here, folks. They don't give up. You don't get outside shoulder on them. I mean, like a pack of wild animals getting after you. If you block them, they get off blocks. Here you watch it, Dominique Douglas. This guy would not surrender right until the cavalry gets there. Fitzhugh comes in with the knockout punch.
Only yielded 96 yards per average on the ground in their first three games, even though they're 1-2. Nesbitt, the pitch man to the corner. That's Smith. Greg Smith can't turn it and gets up to the 42-yard line. It'll be a gain of three. Fitzhugh and Pegues come up and make the tackle for Mississippi State.
Yeah, you have to win the battles on the edge as a cornerback. The wide receiver cornerback battle in this game, this is going to be a big one. And Fitzhugh, once again, Keith comes up and won't surrender. Watch him right side of your screen. There's the pitch. See him out here? He's fighting out there. He wins that battle. He gets off that receiver and gets to the point of attack.
Georgia Tech has an injured player, and it's their offensive center. That's Dan Voss, the junior from Cherry Hill, New Jersey. And he's being tended to face down on the field here. Voss moved over to the center position from the guard position last year, from last year to this year. Starting center graduated, so that's a key position, obviously. And Georgia Tech will come to the sideline to talk things over as Dan Voss is looked at by the training staff. No score. First possession of the game. We'll be back to Atlanta after this. S&K Menswear is the official wardrobe provider for our ACC football broadcast team. S&K Menswear. What are you wearing? Third down, three coming up for Georgia Tech. New center Andrew Faulkner takes the spot of Dan Voss. And here is Roddy Jones in for the first down. At the 46-yard line, a gain of four. He fits you on the tackle for Mississippi State.
Boy, Lucas Cox, watch him. Lucas Cox gets out here. That block right there, folks, that's the block that gets it. And you got to get these guys down. They don't stay down long. Now, you watch this. You're going to get a good example of the option. It's how it goes. Ball is snapped. Pad on pad. You got guys getting out, getting the block, making it happen.
First and 10, Georgia Tech, seventh play of the drive that started at their own 22. Methodically chewing up some small yardage here. This is Peoples to the corner, and he gets into Bulldog territory at the 47-yard line. A nice gain for the true freshman out of Columbus, Georgia. And he's got the first down. Derek McGee's in on the tackle. We'll call that name a lot for Mississippi State this afternoon.
I also like what Mississippi State is doing. David Turner, the defensive line coach, they're rotating guys. So they're going to keep you fresh and keep you active going against this offensive line for the Yellow Jackets.
Eight rushes, no passes. Second down and two. An eight-yard gain for Peoples on first down. Georgia Tech on the Mississippi State side of the field. Here comes Nesbitt. Nice keep. Show fake on his way. And driven out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Damon Glanton was the man who drove him out, the Atlanta native.
Nesbitt, he must have twisted, pulled. Something happened. Man, he had KJ Wright in the trick bag as to what to do. That you see the elements and the benefit of this option, but that's a tough blow for Georgia Tech.
I'll have to come back right now. Looks like Jabo Shaw, the true freshman out of Flowery Branch, Georgia, is going to be in at quarterback. Shaw had a good outing in the second half when he played against Jacksonville State, but this is not Jacksonville State. Here's Dwyer, and Dwyer blows his way into the secondary. Terrell Johnson, redshirt freshman, out of Cullenberg, Alabama, with the tackle. And let's go to the sidelines of Mike Hogwood.
Stevie, he ran right by me when he was coming out of bounds, and he was grabbing the back of his leg, the hamstring area. He is in a lot of pain right now, and that's not a good sign for Georgia Tech.
Looking at the play right now, and he comes up. Oh, yes. He comes up limp near the end of that run. We may be seeing Jabo Shaw for the balance of the afternoon. Here comes the pitch. This is Greg Smith. And Smith driven out of bounds, and all of a sudden, Georgia Tech starts carving up some offense down to the 8-yard line. There'll be a gain on the play of 12. Jasper O'Quinn and Derek Pegues make saving tackles.
You go to Paul Johnson and say, hey, coach, we're going to make you go with your backup center and quarterback. Once again, Cox gets out there, gets in the way, and pretty good football play. When you can get guys like fifth you and you can get them blocked out of a play with very little resistance, you've more than done your job.
Jabo Shaw first and goal from the 8-yard line. The pitch to the corner. This is Peoples. Peoples headed for the pylon. Touchdown, Georgia Tech. Mississippi State player down, and it may be Derek Pegues. Let's see the play again.
Well, you don't get a chance to see this, but 84, Milton, the wide receiver, gets the block, opens up the edge, and you talk about a tough drive. That was a hit-you-in-the-face drive. Georgia Tech signature coming out of the blocks.
Hit-you-in-the-face drive without your starting quarterback, without your starting center.
Boy, that's tough. You know, you say pay attention in meeting rooms, and they... Boy, this is Pegues who is outstanding.
Two game breakers right now down on the field. Of course, earlier we saw Nesbitt. He's getting that hamstring taped up. And, of course, Derek Pegues, who's a key performer. He'll come off under his own power, but weakly to the Mississippi State sideline. Pegues is a good one. He's a senior out of Batesville, Mississippi. He's got 10 career interceptions. Three of them he's brought back for touchdowns.
Yeah, we talked a lot about Jesse Bowman, who's outstanding. I mean, they've got players, and they're rotating guys. Kyle Love, Marcus Williams, Cortez McCurry coming. So they've got ballers.
Scott Blair punctuates the touchdown with a point after kick at the 9:55 mark. It is Emory Peoples. Emory Peoples, a true freshman, pitched to the corner for 8 and a score, and Georgia Tech is on top. We'll be back after this word from your local ACC station. ACC football is brought to you in part by Chevrolet. Now the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets go 11 plays all on the ground, and they march it from their own 22, capped by an Embry Peoples 7-yard touchdown run. Scott Blair getting ready to kick it off now for Georgia Tech as the Yellow Jackets strike first. Derek Pegues, the all-time leading kickoff returner, back on the field after leaving with an injury early on. Here comes Pegues at the 20, and he's upended at the 29-yard line by the kicker, Blair.
He was gone.
Well, fans, get your cell phones ready. It's time for our new interactive feature called the All-Tell Text of War. If we want your answer to this question, which player is more crucial to the Georgia Tech defense? Families of players are not eligible. Text your answer, A1 or A2, to 55333. We'll update the results later in the first half. Could be an interesting question. Wesley Carroll in at quarterback. Anthony Dixon, his running back, Mississippi State. We get a look at them for the first time on offense. Down 7-0. The rollout pass complete to Bell. Aubrey Bell, forward progress to the 34. A gain of 4 on the play. As we recap here, the Mississippi State offense. Brandon McCray, part of a fleet of good receivers. Anthony Dixon, 25 career touchdown runs. Hoskins at fullback, Bell and Henderson. And then in the line, J.C. Brignone, the center. Derek Sherrod, Strader, Gates, and Salisbury. It's second down and 5 after the gain of 5 for Mississippi State. Wesley Carroll's performance will be monitored carefully this afternoon. Here is Dixon, a great downhill runner. And Dixon pushes across the 35 out to the 36-yard line. Morgan Burnett on the tackle. There's Wesley Carroll. He's from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, a true sophomore. Started 9 games last year and won 6 of them. Pressed into service. He's had his struggles at the start of this season, and he's faced with a key 3rd and 4. Mississippi State did not convert a single 3rd down against Auburn a week ago. So here they go. Bell split wide out. McCray to the other side. Out of the shotgun, Terrell. Passes to the flats. It is complete to Brandon McCray. And he's hauled down back there by Mario Butler. And their first down conversion, Doc, in 2 weeks.
Nothing bigger for the psyche than to come out, first of all, complete your first down pass, get in the minimum position here, and then complete. Throw and catch. The key on that is Salisbury getting Derek Morgan down. Also on the left side, Sherrod getting him down. See, getting those ends cut is the vision, sight line.
First and 10. Ball out to the 45-yard line, and the snap is fumbled and it's picked up by Georgia Tech. Michael Johnson flattened on the ground. The play a go. Comes up with a big play on a weird snap from center.
Boy, as a coach, you just have to scratch your head. Coach Cromie said we get a good start, then we come out, and Georgia Tech didn't have anything to do with this. They're the recipient, you know, of a gift.
Oh, the center just, he launched it into the seats.
It's called adrenaline.
That's J.C. Brignone.
Yeah.
And Michael Johnson gets a gift, and Georgia Tech takes over. They're at the Mississippi State 40-yard line. Jabo Shaw back in there at quarterback. Shaw on the option. Grab from behind. Slowed up by Terrell Johnson. And finally flattened there by K.J. Wright.
Boy, that's a good piece of running back. Running it down from the backside. Redshirt freshman, 210-pounder. He mentioned Terrell Johnson. Now, it's hard to defend that or to block it because you don't block that guy. You don't think
that
guy would be a factor.
If you're going away from him.
He was smoking down the line.
And Wright starting at the Will linebacker. Second down and 5. Faulkner is still in there at center with Jabo Shaw, the quarterback, the two freshmen. Big pitch, set up to throw. Had no time, but does get it complete. Close to the first down. Here's Dwyer resetting the field. Dwyer knocked out of bounds at the 16. The play originally had enough for the first down. He got 14 extra yards.
And that's, you're born with this, man. You don't draw it up this way. No coach would. This kid has major skills. Great pressure on the edge once again. Forced it. And then at this point, how do you know this is going to happen? Those good football players. That's LaMarcus Williams. He just shreds and then is able to go north-south. It all starts with pressure. That's right in your face.
That's Fitzhugh on the blitz. First and 10. All at the 15-yard line after a 20-yard game. And now Jabo Shaw wants a timeout. He'll come to the sideline, and he's probably going to catch it from Paul Johnson right now.
Coach Harbison's sending the dogs after him now.
Timeout on the field. Georgia Tech in the red zone. We'll be back with him right after this. For today's telecast provided by Bojangles, you've got to want to need to get a habit. Bojangles.
I love that.
First and 10, Georgia Tech at the Mississippi State 15. That's Ronnie Jones in motion, and he gets the pitch and gets caught up with Damian Anderson as soon as he received the ball for a loss of 5 on the play.
Man, there's nothing that's more disruptive than penetration.
Let's head to the sidelines right now. Mike Hogwood.
Well, injury update for you, Josh Nesbitt. It is confirmed. It's a hamstring. It is doubtful he'll be back today. Also, the starting center, Steve, you talked about him, Dan Voss. Also doubtful that he'll be back for the rest of this game today.
So we've got a new battery in there. You've got Andrew Faulkner, and Jabo Shaw likely in for the duration. Second down and 15. Ball at the 20-yard line. Back to throw with pressure as he throws into the end zone. Did he get it? Touchdown, Georgia Tech! Demaryius Thomas with the score.
How do you say it any better? A game of inches, just a second here or there. You say it any way you want to. Damian Anderson is steamrolling off the edge. 3-2 in your back. You got to give Shaw a lot of credit. Stays strong, has just enough on it to get it to the end zone.
And the Yellow Jackets are up 2 scores. Demaryius Thomas, who did not play last week, has his 5th career touchdown pass and the 1st of the season. And now we've got a review as to whether or not Demaryius Thomas made the catch or whether the ball hit the ground yet. And this is a Booth review. Paul Johnson.
You know, they say all good quarterbacks have eyes in the back of their head. Sometimes you need to blink. Because if Shaw is able to see this, and we take another look from this angle, great effort defensively.
Not much you can tell from there. I mean, he's got the ball. This will probably tell us.
Let's see.
And
has hands on it.
Oh, that's a catch.
You hit the ground. Yeah. You come up. He's got it.
He's got it. I mean, they may see something different, but Doc and I think this is a catch.
Yeah.
Those are pretty good coverage.
Yep.
Mississippi State defensively, the Bulldogs, they're tough out. I'm telling you, if you get something on it, you're going to get hit in the face.
Well, their two passes have been designed the same way. They've gotten the pressure there just a shade late.
Looks like Coach Harbison has turned up the intensity, the new center, new quarterback, and they're getting there in time. They're just a second field.
After review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. It is a touchdown.
All right, here's 31 plays reviewed this season under instant replay, 7 overturned, 17 of 22 games with at least one stoppage, and the average delay about a minute and a half.
See, Voss just came back on the field for the Yellow Jackets, and he doesn't appear to be like he's in any kind of pain. I wonder what happened. Well, Hogwood will get us the 4-1-1 on it.
Scott Blair gets the point after. Let's take a look at the touchdown pass, and look at the pressure from the right of your screen. That's Damian Anderson again.
Anderson is not shy. You have to give this kid, J-Bo Shaw, a lot of credit, man. Impromptu service called in. And, of course, Thomas with the grab and a score for the Yellow Jackets.
And it's all set up, remember, by the gimme fumble with a snap from center that went over Wesley Carroll's head. 4 plays later, Georgia Tech found the end zone for the second time in this first quarter. And that was Demaryius Thomas with a 20-yard touchdown pass reception from J-Bo Shaw.
Good teams punish you for mistakes. Average teams kick field goals. Teams that aren't very good would have turned the ball back over. So that gives you a pretty good example of where the Yellow Jackets are right now. When you get, especially with that field position, you cash in for 7. That's a big move for Georgia Tech.
Our Chevrolet Stars of the Week in the ACC. Offensive Back of the Week, Thaddeus Lewis. What about the Duke Blue Devils romping over Navy 41-31? The Rookie of the Week, Darren Evans, running back out of Virginia Tech. Career-high 95 yards rushing and a touchdown in the win over these Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets last week. For more information, go to RaycomSports.com.
Looking forward to seeing Duke. Huh? We'll see Duke. This new Duke look.
David Cutcliffe's done a nice job with him.
All right, he's a good coach.
Pegues lets this one right out of the end zone. Scott Blair, the do-everything kicker for the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets, who leads them in punting, has just kicked one out of the end zone, and Mississippi State will take it out at the 20 for their second possession of the day. Now, this broadcast is a copyright presentation of Raycom Sports. Any use of this broadcast without the express permission of the Atlantic Coast Conference and Raycom Sports is prohibited. A beautiful day here in Atlanta. Steve Martin, Rick Doc Walker, Mike Hogwood at historic Grant Field, part of Bobby Dodd Stadium, the oldest football bowl series stadium on campus in the country. Carroll on 1st and 10. This is going to be Dixon. Big hole up the middle. He's headed upfield. At the 30, not pulled down there, finally drawn down at the 8-yard line. Morgan Burnett makes a saving tackle, and the Bulldogs explode on 1st down, 71 yards downfield.
They say, how you like me now? Watch this right here, folks. So you're going after a good athlete. They have 2 guys on him. They get Michael Johnson down. And this is the foot race. Anthony Dixon, the 240-pound junior. He's scooting it down there. And not yet. That shows you why speed of Morgan Burnett is priceless in the secondary.
Jaheward Daniels got the first chance, but Burnett had to finish him off. 1st and goal, Mississippi State. Here's Dixon. turns the corner and driven down at the 5-yard line. The tackle again, Morgan Burnett. But another 3 yards for this impressive back who continues to climb up the charts of Mississippi State. He's in the top 10 rushing, closing in on 2,000 yards. Matter of fact, he's dangerously close. He had 1,910 coming in, then a 71-yard run.
Yeah, but he better buy milkshake for Eric Hoskins because the fullback gave him that edge with a great block at the point of attack.
Second down and goal from the 5. 14-0 Georgia Tech with Mississippi State threatening. Hand off Elliott. Elliott surges down to the 1. Burnett makes a hit, also making a tackle. Dominique Reese, sophomore out of Auburn, Alabama. And we have a penalty flag back at the 5-yard line.
Well, the Bulldogs can ill afford to kill their own momentum. When you're the road team and you're trailing 14-0, man, you got to make something happen. You haven't had the first down. You're 0 for 14 before converting. You got a fumble. That shows you a lot about the heart of the Bulldogs.
Well, we're talking to Mississippi State. And it's going to be a penalty against Georgia Tech. It looks like it's going to be declined because it's the 1-foot line. Hubert Owens is going to tell us all about it.
Offside. Number 93 on the defense. That penalty is declined. It will be third down.
So it brings up third. You could have had second over, but you'd be back at the 5.
Well, this is a manhood issue now because you're a yard away from doing what needs to be done. Look at that wall. Boy, that's body on body. Gates, Salisbury getting it done up front.
Hoskins and Dixon out of the backs. Here's Dixon. Hit in the backfield. And shot down by Cedric Griffin, the junior from Blair, South Carolina.
My, my, my. Let me take another look at that. Who wants to be a hero? Look at the pile right here. That's where you got to get, folks. Right there in the circle. You got to find out whether or not you want to hit the Bulldog. Look at the penetration there by Johnson. 6'7", 260 pounds with leverage. Big play for the Yellow Jackets.
Adam Carlson on for the field goal. He's 2 for 4, as long as it's 41. This will be an 18-footer right down the center of the field. The hole by Aaron Fell. Kick is up. No! No good, and Michael Johnson got a hand on it.
Wow. The rambling record saying, you get nothing. Oh, my goodness. Down on the 1-foot-yard line and rejected. Here you watch it. This is the play. Manhood issue. Dayton going up top. Look at the Yellow Jackets. Low man wins. Not a block. Inside, 6'7", Michael Johnson, right there, gets the block. Yellow Jacket rejection.
Had a player down for Mississippi State. One of their offensive players, he's hurt. We've had some players get hurt here this afternoon. That's Michael Gates. He's a senior right guard from Fairburn, Georgia.
Man, when you're a senior, that looks like one of those that you may not recover from, and he knows it. I mean, you a lot of spring ball, weights, training, stairs, stadium stairs, missing vacations. You put a lot into this, and to get in as a senior and not be able to finish, man, it's just gut-wrenching.
Well, this isn't what we imagined. Other scores elsewhere. You see NC State and East Carolina going at it. .349 left to go in the first quarter. That East Carolina-NC State game, that's quite a rivalry. That's for the eastern half of the state of North Carolina. They both live there. But Georgia Tech, and there's Michael Johnson. Got a hand up and blocked the field goal attempt.
Do the Bobcats need to look at this kid?
Well, everybody in the
I'm
NBA.
Just telling you, man, you're talking about Rejection City.
I'll tell you what, he's going to be playing Sunday for a long time. First and 10, Georgia Tech at their own 20. Hand off inside. No, it's going to be a pitch to Roddy Jones. He's on his horse and brought out of bounds by Fitzhugh. But not before he made a gain of 21 yards. Keith Fitzhugh with a saving tackle, a collar.
There's no lack of effort in this broadcast, in this effort. Watch number 36, right side of your screen, right there. You just get a little bit of that. That is Lucas Cox, 238-pound human hammer. I mean, this guy's getting people down on the ground. There's a pitch. This is the beauty of this spread offense. You get out on the edge with execution, you're hard to stop.
Roddy Jones out of Stone Mountain, Georgia, with a big gain of 21. Jay Bo Shaw pitches, it's loose, and Jones covers it up for a loss of three. Shaw got leveled as soon as he let go of the ball, maybe as K.J. Wright in on him.
One thing I've seen in just a short period of time watching the Bulldogs on defense, buddy, they make you, they bring it every play.
Oh, yeah.
You beat them, you better execute. This is a very impressive group.
Well, we're calling linebackers and DBs in the air in the Georgia Tech.
That's in the backfield, man.
Dan Voss is back out at center. And Jabo Shaw is behind him. Wire the long setback. On second and 13, here's Shaw to throw, and he aims at the tuba.
Yeah, but you see the closing speed of Dominique Douglas. I mean, these guys, it's hard to describe how fast that kick took away that margin, that closing speed. To see him on film is one thing, but to see these guys here up front, now I understand what Auburn was up against in that 3-2 game.
Our first and 10 line is brought to you by SeatExchange.com, the official ticket exchange partner of the ACC. Third and 14 now for Georgia Tech. They've made their first third down conversion. Pass, a screen to Demaryius Thomas. He tries to jump over some would-be tacklers. Gets a little bit of room, about four. Jasper O'Quinn on the tackle.
Yeah, Quinn did a really good job, as most of the Bulldogs have done all day on defense. If you beat them, boy, you just got to have second effort. Very impressive thus far. I mean, despite the score, you just tuned in, you look at it, and you go, what am I talking about? You watch this. Now I understand why Mississippi State is so recognized with their defensive effort.
Scott Blair, the leading punter in the ACC, with a 45.1 average, and Derek Pegues, who's returned three in his career for touchdowns. This is a short one, taken at the 22. Pegues brought down at the 32-yard line. It's a 38-yard punt, a gain of 11. It's our first punt of the day by either side. Mississippi State takes over the football for the third time. They fumbled the first time. They missed a field goal the second time. Sky's the limit here.
Well, also, though, they've got to have amnesia. They got to forget about what just happened. You get a run. They're on the doorstep.
Right.
They got nothing. So now, you know, they got to hang in this. They got to say to themselves, remember what good we did, and let's duplicate it.
Under two to play in his first quarter. Brandon McRae has a slot back to the right side. Aubrey Bell split wide to the top. They're coming the other way. And a handoff will go to Elliott. And Elliott gets a little bit of running room out to about the 35-yard line. Back up.
Robert Hall. Yeah, Robert Hall did a real good job keeping those shoulders square. And, you know, they got a lot of talent at defensive line for Coach Dave Womack and these Yellow Jackets.
Well, they got backups on the entire right side. The two right side guys are backups. You got Derek Morgan and Vance Walker on the other side. Second down now and seven. Carroll out of the shotgun. Fires, pass complete to McCray at the 40, and he lunges ahead to the 41-yard line. Butler on the tackle. It's going to be a gain of about six. It'll bring up third and one.
Well, that's what we talked about in the open. Third and one. You want to have manageable third down opportunities. One thing I've seen just in Carroll, boy, got a whip. He can get it out there.
Well, you know, I talked to Coach Kuhlman on Thursday, and he was a little question Wesley Carroll's decision-making capability this season. Today, he seems to be having a pretty good day.
And he's got a gun. I mean, he can throw it.
We got a timeout called here with 33 seconds left in the first quarter. It's going to be charged to Mississippi State. They'll talk things over here. as they face a key third down conversion. Well, we've had a lot of fireworks in this game. Anthony Dixon going for 71 yards, two Georgia Tech touchdowns. And here with more is Mike Hogwood down on the sideline.
Thanks, Steve. You know, I want to reiterate what Doc said. It's a war in the trenches down here. But I'm on the Mississippi State sideline, and on that last possession, after they came off, after not making it and third and a foot to get in, there were some, I'll just say it, really mad players down here. And you get the feeling when their coaches were talking that this is an important drive for the psyche of this Mississippi State offense, shut out a week ago by Auburn. They are really determined. That might be one of the reasons they called the timeout, to make sure they've got the right play called here. This is an important drive.
Oh, no doubt about it, Mike. And Doc, if Georgia Tech were to get the ball back and punch another one in here in the first quarter, I think it'd be very difficult for Mississippi State to maintain that offensive continuity. That forces Carroll to pass just about every time. Carroll hands off to Dixon. Dixon is going to have enough for the first down, but not without the efforts of Morgan Burnett. In on the tackle along with Dominique Reese, but it's not before Dixon has picked up and moved the chains. And that's something that Mississippi State, we said, laid it out in our keys, Doc. Said that Mississippi State's going to move the chains, and they're doing a much better job of it today than they did last week.
Much more impressive here than they were on film.
First and 10, hand off Dixon. Looking for a hole, and there is nothing but Yellow Jackets. And leading the charge, Vance Walker, as well as Michael Johnson.
What a stud. I mean, Vance Walker.
There's Johnson at 6'7".
Yeah.
He's got a block kick, and he's also got a fumble recovery. The Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets excite their home fans with a 14-0 lead after one here in Atlanta. Closed captioning for today's telecast provided by Bojangles. You've got to want to need again to have a Bojangles. Welcome back to Atlanta. Start of the second quarter. First and 10. Actually, second down and 10 coming up here for Mississippi State. They trail Georgia Tech 14-0. Wesley Carroll on the snap. Pass downfield complete. The catch made by Jamail Smith, fifth-year senior out of East Point, Georgia.
Good pass, bro. Really good pass protection. And you can pick up people. He slides in the pocket, finds the open man. Again, Wesley Carroll's been impressive. And you watch that pocket. So he's able to slide over, just sliding over just a little bit. Good recognition. And that's what you want. If they, you know, as they told me before the game, talking to the staff, we got to handle our business first. That's a pretty good indication.
10-yard gain. Carroll now 3 for 3. So, yes, Doc, he's looked pretty good today. Double reverse. Here comes a hand off to the inside back, Elliott, and he gets thrown for a loss of 2 back to the 49-yard line of Georgia Tech. Now time for our Progress Energy Progress Report as we look at first quarter stats. Georgia Tech leads on the ground and in the air and on the scoreboard. Of course, the 2 scores, and of course, the big turnover that resulted in a score 4 plays later after the bad snap from center recovered by Michael Johnson. Second down and 11 now facing the Bulldogs. After the loss of 1. Out of the shotgun, Carroll, 3-step drop and a hit. And it's to Jamail Smith again. And he's 4 for 4 on the afternoon, out to the 38-yard line. Another 10-yard completion, shy of the first down.
It was very important for Mississippi State to establish a running presence. They've done that. They've had the big run. Now they're showing you now that they can mix it up. And eventually, then you make a guy miss, they're going to have a big play out of it. But they've got to get on the scoreboard.
Christian Dupree is in the ballgame along with Elliott. Out of the shotgun, Wesley Carroll on 3rd down and 1. Mississippi State 2 out of 3 on 3rd. Hand off Elliott. Second effort may get in the first down. Let's see where they spot him. Tackle made on the play by Aris Anyabi, fifth-year senior from DeSoto, Texas. And he's going to be shy, and it's 4th down. 4th down and inches, and looks like they're going to bring the punting unit on.
Nope. They're going for a win.
Yep, they're outside of field goal range. They think their offense can get 12 inches. Hoskins and Dixon, the running back. Hand off Dixon to the corner. Tackled. Jahee Ward-Daniels throws him for a loss. And Georgia Tech takes over on defense and downs.
And they have to feel like Hercules. Well, this is twice now where they've been tested and come up big. First in the middle, this time they tried to bounce it. You can't bounce it because of the penetration, Morgan and company. Well, it's just too much penetration. Georgia Tech captured the line of scrimmage. And if that happens, buddy, you're in trouble.
Loss of seven on the play. Georgia Tech takes over. Good field position at their own 45-and-a-half-yard line. Cox in motion. First man through Dwyer and nothing there. McCraney and Dominique Douglas in there on the tackle. Cortez McCraney, the senior, fifth-year senior, South Haven, Mississippi.
And that's just controlling again the line. When you can do that right at the line of scrimmage, I mean, Cortez never moved.
Second down and nine. McCraney's right on the center. Here's the pitch in the eyes of Embry Peoples. He turns the corner and gets the first down in Bulldog territory at the 43.
Boy, McCraney had outstanding penetration on that play. Dan Voss back at center for the Yellow Jackets. If you get a chance to watch this right in there, folks, I mean, that's getting it done. But the Yellow Jackets had a bounce. They had the right play called at the right time.
A gain of 10 on the play brings up another first down, this time in Mississippi State territory, where Georgia Tech spent a lot of time so far in this first down. This is Dwyer.
Yeah, he's special.
And he's tripped up by Glanton. But not before he made a nice, healthy gain here of about 6 yards.
He really is unique. It's little things. You make a guy miss in the middle of a hole like that, just, you know, you save yourself a hit.
Had 100-yard days the first two games of the season. Was overshadowed by Josh Nesbitt last week. But getting on the horse now for 6 yards here to bring up second down and four.
Yeah, I thought he sustained a thigh bruise last week against the Hokies as well. I think he missed some time.
Second down and about four. Handoff goes to Dwyer, and good helmet-to-helmet contact there. And it's good enough for the first down on second effort to the 32. He went head-on into Dominique Douglas, and Dwyer won. Today's game is brought to you in part by Nissan and your local Nissan dealer. As we gaze across the beautiful skyline of Atlanta, Georgia, on a day perfect for football. About 72 degrees here. Nice breeze. Great day to take in football action here on one of the most historic fields in the country. The oldest on-campus facility for the World Championship Series teams. Here's the pitch to Dwyer, takes to the corner and more. First down and brought out of bounds at the horse collar tackle off the geese as flags fly from three directions. 13-yard gain on the play. Let's see what the discussion centers around. It was one in back of the play and two right where he went out of bounds. We're thinking horse collar, but there might be another penalty at play here.
Well, I'll tell you what. I hope we get to show David Brown's effort. 280-pound senior right tackle.
Hubert Owens.
There were multiple fouls on the play. Personal foul, tripping. Number 55 on the offense. Holding. Number 20 on the offense. Personal foul, false collar tackle. On the defense, those penalties are offset. We will replay first down.
Replay first down, but take away the first down gain. That would have put Georgia Tech in the red zone for the third time this afternoon. And it backs them up to the 33-yard line where we'll just forget the whole last 20 seconds happened.
Well, you have to. And I like David's athleticism, but, yeah, you don't have to go down at the end with the clip. Stay high. He's been in good shape.
Georgia Tech working with good field position. They took over on downs this drive at the 45-yard line. They scored four plays after a turnover. And they also had an impressive 11-play all-run march on their first possession of the afternoon. Handoff. Straight ahead. This is Quincy Kelly, his first carry of the day. And Kyle Lowe comes up with the tackle for Mississippi State. Back to the sidelines we go to Mike Hockwood.
We've been talking about this war in the trenches. And right now, that offensive line of Georgia Tech, despite that holding by David Brown, has been pretty good. And particularly Andrew Gardner, another fifth-year senior, one of the best offensive linemen in the ACC. And he's the real leader of this offensive line. He's got him going from that left tackle spot. They are really playing well up front.
Second down and seven. And off again, Quincy Kelly, second straight carry. Glanton brings him down after about a 4.5-yard gain. It gets him close to the 25-yard line, but leaves him about 2 or maybe 3 yards shy of the first down.
Glanton's not shy, is he?
Oh, no. 12 tackles on the season, 4 career interceptions. He's a good one.
Now he'll come downhill and get you to the end. And what Mike Hogwood's comments about the offensive line, which even makes it better, Mike, is the level of competition they're facing. I mean, I'm highly impressed with the Bulldogs on the defensive side, so it's their volumes.
Third down and 3. Wire back as a setback now. Here's Jabo Shaw. Looks like a busted play.
That ball's out.
Who's got it?
That ball is out.
Blow it dead, and who's got it? That play looked busted from the start.
Yeah.
And it looks like Jabo Shaw got on it and recovered the fumble.
That's no easy task.
No, it isn't.
To be at the bottom of one of those piles.
Dominique Douglas is in there, and this is going to be fourth down. No kicking unit in here now. This would be a 42-yard field goal if they would try it, but they're not going to. They're going to go for it on fourth down and 3 at the 25. Thomas and Clyburn are wide out. Jabo Shaw on the option. Takes it on his own. He's got it at it. The first down and a touchdown for Georgia Tech. Jabo Shaw's second career touchdown run. He's already had a touchdown pass earlier in this game. 25 yards on 4th and 3.
Boy, there's some beautiful things that this offense can deliver. 4th and 3. Little sense of dog. The Bulldogs brought some pressure.
Scott Blair's kick is good. And the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets are up by 3 scores now. This time, Jabo Shaw runs 25 yards, calling his own number for the score. Today's game is brought to you by Altel, the official wireless partners of fans. A lot of new fans of Jabo Shaw, as you see the true freshman quarterback capped a 8-play march with a 25-yard run on 4th and 3. He's a dual-threat quarterback out of Flowery Branch, Georgia. Father played football at Western Carolina, so there's some pedigree there in the family. And we got a whistle. We've got a flag on the play. A fair catch called for on the kickoff, and he ran anyway. And that was Stallworth.
The ball is dead on possession. First down.
So there's a mistake on the kicking games. Now time to update our Altel Text of War poll. We're asking you which player is more crucial to the Georgia Tech defense, and Michael Johnson's winning 70-30% over Vance Walker. You see the results right now. Add your voice to the vote. Text your answer, A1 or A2, to 55333. And thanks for participating in Altel's Text of War. First and 10 at the 15, Mississippi State. Carroll rolls out, sprints out to the left side, fires the ball, too high, picked off by Jahewer Daniels. Georgia Tech's got the football again, thanks to the the senior from Hoover, Alabama, Jahewer Daniels, with the interception.
First crew is going to have to think, boy, when it rains, it pours. Running to the left. Of course, the ball got a little high from him. Now, good action on it. You have what you want. You have the flat. You got the trail. But the ball's just thrown improperly. Goes out there, and then that just... It happens that you don't get the shoulders turned around. You just don't see it. The vision just wasn't there.
And Georgia Tech has an excellent opportunity here to put a fourth score on the board. They're in deep in Bulldog territory. Shaw scrambles out of the pocket. Brought down from behind and tackled after a three-yard gain by Jesse Bowman. Senior from Brookhaven, Mississippi. There's Bowman, the reigning SEC defensive lineman of the week. We talked to Sylvester Croom. He says he's got the best bad body of anybody in the SEC.
Hard to block him.
And there's Jahewer Daniels, his first interception this season, his fifth of his career. And he sets up the Yellow Jackets in perfect field position. There's second play from scrimmage, second and nine. And it's from the 26-yard line. Pitch comes to Dwyer, pursued on the corner, and driven out of bounds. K.J. Wright of Olive Branch, Mississippi, makes the stop and drives him out of bounds. One of the few plays that Georgia Tech lost yardage to. And here's the rush defense. On the season, Mississippi State has allowed 96. However, today, they've given up 151. And this is the first half.
That's the bad news.
Yeah. Is there any good news if you're a Bulldog fan?
Well, that they won't quit. And, you know that. If you follow Mississippi State, they won't quit. But they need some points.
Yellow Jackets on third down. Shaw is collapsed upon. And again, right there on the tackle. Also, Kyle Love, Terrell Johnson, all in on the stop.
Talk about a load. Try to block Love. 6'1", by 320. And if they list you at 320, that means you know we're in the neighborhood of 320.
You're in some other neighborhood.
Some other neighborhood, yeah. That's for the program.
It was a running play officially, so it's fourth down and 17. And this is going to be a punt coming up by Scott Blair, the ACC's leading punter.
Doesn't seem like much, but Bulldogs needed to get a stop.
Yeah, they did. After a turnover. Flag down on the play. Here's the punt, and it takes Mississippi State bounce and comes out to the 13-yard line, but we have a penalty flag back at the 35. Eric Morgan down the ball, but let's see what Hubert Owens and crew come up with. So Mississippi State doesn't give away the turnover. A 21-yard punt.
They may have to do it again.
It's going to be against Georgia Tech. It's an illegal motion. So they'll talk to Derek Pegues, and likely, and you're right, Doc, they'll probably make him kick it over. 5:44 left to go in this first half. Georgia Tech has been impressive.
Illegal shift on the offense. Two men moving prior to the snap. That penalty is 5 yards. Added to the end of the kick. First down.
So they'll take it after the kick and bring it out to the 18-yard line. Timeout on the field with Georgia Tech leading 21-0 over Mississippi State. Back after this word from your local ACC station. 44 remaining in our first half. Georgia Tech leading Mississippi State in this intra-conference battle. In Atlanta, Mississippi State with the football after the punt and the penalty. At their own 18, this is Anthony Dixon, and Dixon surges ahead. Good looking back, and he's brought down there. Anthony Barnes, among others. Darrell Richard tripped him up. Anthony Barnes, interesting situation for him. He gets his first action in a couple of weeks. He had a shoulder injury. He's a sophomore working at that outside linebacker spot. Second down and 2 after the gain of 8. Here comes the pitch, and here comes Dixon. And he dances over a tackler. What a move by Dixon. Who did he hurdle over? That was Dominique Reese. Rashard Reed comes up for the tackle.
Man, that's a photographer's delight right here. A la Joe Washington in Oklahoma, 1960.
74. Wow.
I mean, that's worth another look.
Oh, right over Rashad Reed.
Yeah, that's special.
What a play. And Morgan comes up with a tackle. Third and one for Mississippi State. They are 2 for 4 on third downs. This is a very short one. McCray in motion. Hand off Dixon. Hit in the backfield, but surges ahead for that first down. Darryl Richard hit him, but couldn't prevent a load when he gets going. Anthony Dixon from converting it to first down at the 32.
Yeah, pretty good surge again on the left side. They needed this for self-esteem purposes. You know, they've been stopped now twice. This time you watch the pad placement. Good job up front. And then again you're able to keep it going, get your confidence. You know, you look at it, doesn't look good now, but we've seen things happen in a half of football.
Carroll under center on first and 10 from his own 32. Play action. Hit as he threw by Johnson, and it falls harmlessly. Michael Johnson with the quarterback pressure.
Yeah, he's better than advertised.
Yeah.
And you look at it, the play action, well, it doesn't bite. You don't get credit for it. Look inside. Look at Walker's penetration. I mean, these are like cavemen. They come at you from all different angles. They're physical. They feel good about where they are right now. They got the score. Ben, look at it bouncing. This is how you want to play the game, man, when you're holding all the aces.
Anyabi is in a defensive tackle now. Second down and 10. Carroll under pressure. Complete. This is going to be to Hoskins, and the tackle made by Rashad Reed. And he makes a nice gain on the play. Out to the 40-yard line, that makes it an 8-yard gain.
Good tackle by Reed, because that might have gone for the first down. Bulldogs won't die, but I guarantee you, Georgia Tech's trying to strangle him.
Rashad Reed and Cooper Taylor are two freshman DBs who made some interesting plays this year, and they're really contributing. Third down and one again. Mississippi State's length of third downs getting shorter. That's
yes,
a good sign.
But they're going to have to go for it for the rest of the ballgame.
Play action for Carroll on third and one. Pass complete to Hoskins, and it's good for the first down at the 48-yard line. Action to make it the 45, and it'll be a gain of 5 on the play. But it keeps moving the chains for the Bulldogs, who started this drive at their own 18.
And good for them, because going on the ground wasn't cutting it. They went up top. Vance Walker just had a behemoth rush. These guys up front are really good.
Seventh play of the drive. Hand off Dixon, and Dixon gets tripped up and flattened, making the first stop on Yavi. And then Vance Walker came over to help out.
Now, you've mentioned all of them, Richard, Anyabi, Walker, Anderson, Morgan. How many of them are there? It's a question you got to say to yourself.
They got 7 that they've shown a lot of here, 7 of the 4 positions.
And they can play.
They got another guy in there on this down. This is Jason Peters. He's out at that right defensive end, replacing Michael Johnson. Second down and 10. Carroll with a play fake, pass complete. Shy of the first, second down, may get it. It's to Elliott, Robert Elliott, out of the backfield. And it's going to be close to the first down. He's got it.
See, Elliott, some guys don't play up to their size. This kid's more than 95. Watch him there. Stay strong with those legs. He made that time in the squat, on those squat racks, pay off for him. If they pick this up, big time for the Bulldogs.
They've got the first down, and they've got a timeout call with 1:58 left to go. They've got one timeout remaining. So a timeout on the field, and the Bulldogs moving. Georgia Tech leads Mississippi State 21-0. 21-0. Georgia Tech leading Mississippi State. 1:58 left to go. Bulldogs trying to pick it up as they get into Georgia Tech territory here. Out of the shotgun, Carlson. The pass underneath the Bell, and it is complete. Aubrey Bell, a senior from Pritchard, Alabama. Shy of the first down, Cedric Griffin makes the tackle. No huddle offense here for the Bulldogs as they pick up 7 yards to make it 2nd and 3.
I like Griffin. He's a playmaker.
He's around the ball, made one big play on the goal line. Pretty good linebacker.
And second and three, short pass to Brendan McCray, completes. And another first down. That stops the clock briefly at the 25 to reset. Of course, you stop the clock.
Derek Morgan's pretty slow to get up on that. Had a function at the junction on this one, maybe one of his own teammates.
And this will help. It's an official's timeout for Morgan to get off the field. As he was shaken up on the play. It's a 13-yard gain on the pass play to Brendan McCray. And it sets Mississippi State up at the 26-yard line of Georgia Tech. Listen, the final 2 minutes to stop the clock on a first down or a pass out of bounds. And it doesn't start again until the ball is snapped. Here is Carlson, and he is deflected by Morgan Burnett. Wesley Carroll's pass deflected as he threw it right into the hand of Morgan Burnett.
Well, Morgan Burnett committed himself, got in. I thought he'd be blocked at the point of attack. Again, Carroll going to the left. I think he expected to get a little bit more help out of his back. I think that's what happened on that. I really thought he was going to get a little more help.
Second down and 10. Clock at 1:17. Stopped on the incompletion. This is the longest amount of time that Mississippi State's hung on to the football today. Back to throw. And it is incomplete. Carroll looking downfield for Coeric Riley. Covering.
A little bit of a bracket coverage on him. I mean, you're trying to keep these werewolves away from him. And you may have to just put handcuffs on Michael Johnson. I don't know if you put two men on him, beat two, beat one. Man, what a player.
Nail him to the turf. Do something. Third down and 10 now.
Bribe him.
Mississippi State is 4 of 6 on third down conversions, but none bigger than this one right here. Carroll to throw. Steps up, fires, pass to Riley, broken up. Flag on the play. Cooper Taylor covering on the play. That may be interference. He might have hit him a little too early.
I'm going to take that might out of it for you. Okay. He got there too soon.
Paul Johnson.
Wesley Carroll. He put a little mustard on it.
He did. It was a good ball. And Taylor just hit him too early.
Pass interference. Number 22 on the defense. That penalty was 15 yards from the previous
true freshman.
It carries an automatic first down.
He's physical. I like a kid that's physical. Carroll under pressure.
Yep. Yeah. He gets there and then the ball goes right off.
Just a little bit. Now, I'll take it. You know what? Son, come in there and bring some heat with you and we'll be okay. We'll get over it.
At the 11, they can still get a first down. Carroll pass complete. This is Bell. And he struggled to get to the 8. The clock continues to run as the ball stayed in play. Cedric Griffin on the tackle. Mississippi State has one timeout left, but they don't want to use it here. Second down and 7. They can get a first down inside the 1. Now we got a whistle.
Looks like Henderson was too eager.
Yeah, and he and Craig Jenkins pulled up early.
They must have called his number. Your heart starts to beat a little faster when they call you a number.
Yeah.
I mean, that's for real. So let's not act like that doesn't happen.
We play second down.
False start. Now, stops the clock, but it pushes them back to the 13-yard line.
The snap. The interception. Self-inflicted wounds. That's what coach is going to get in at halftime and tell his guys, you know, we can't beat ourselves and the Jackets. Jackets are pretty good.
Let's take ourselves out of the quotient.
Yeah.
Second down and 12. And now Mississippi State is going to use the timeout here. So it's a Mississippi State timeout. It's their final timeout. And here's a look at our Heisman in the ACC. John Heisman, of course, changed the face of the game in America's. It is America's passion. No one more thoroughly studied the dynamics of football, nor witnessed more closely the game's evolution and development. Much of the official rule book adopted Heisman's suggestions word for word. John Heisman spent 16 years of his coaching career here at Georgia Tech. And 2 months before his death in 1936, the trophy for the best football player was renamed, as you know, the Heisman Memorial Trophy. National championships, of course, they win them. The guy wrote the rule book. 1917, 1928.
It is a slight advantage, huh?
1952 and 1990, the last time that the Yellow Jackets won the national championship.
And we got a chance to spend some time with Coach Bobby Ross.
Yes.
Last week up at Clemson.
He's a
class act.
Yep, working radio. Mm-hmm. 14th play of this drive, second down and 12 to go. They can get a first down inside the one. And we have a problem here on the snap, and another flag is thrown, stopping the clock with 27 seconds left.
Center didn't snap. Everybody seemed to go.
Prior to the snap, false start. Number 55 on the offense. That penalty is 5 yards from the previous spot. It's still third down.
That's Salisbury.
They really held on to the ball.
Yeah, center held on. Yeah. 11 guys, 10 guys left, one guy said, I don't know you.
Boy, this would be like taking a helium out of a big bounce.
Second down.
If they can get in.
Second down and 16 at the 17-yard line. Carroll out of the shotgun. Johnson with the pressure. Hits it as he throws. Ball's incomplete and stops the clock with 24 seconds. That's about the third or fourth quarterback pressure for Michael Johnson.
Yeah, it's almost impossible to block him with one guy. And that's what Mississippi State is opting to do right now. He just beat Salisbury with his hands.
Boy, he's lucky.
I mean, that was almost a perfect no-hitter.
He almost got a face mask.
Yeah, that's true. At 6'7", that's probably an occupational hazard for him.
Yeah.
But they're going to have to keep the tight end Henderson on his side bump because it's just not working for him.
Bell, McCray, a wide out to the top side, Dupree and Riley to the bottom. Carroll over the middle, intercepted. Morgan Burnett at the 1 yard line. Mississippi State runs 14 plays and comes up empty again.
And Riley mistimed his jump. Man, they can't wait to get in at halftime. Pretty good pass throw in the circumstances. That wasn't a problem. He just mistimed his jump.
He's coming down. You're right.
He's coming down. The ball's coming to him. Good blitz pickup.
That was the tight end also looking at it, too.
And I got to give Chambers credit. Travis, great drop. He got right in the throwing zone.
Well, Georgia Tech at their own 2 yard line. And they'll just push it ahead here and get into the locker room and try not to run. They don't have to run another play here in this first half. They've done enough damage. The Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets have forced 3 turnovers. They've pitched a shutout defensively. That young man, true freshman Jabo Shaw, has run for his second touchdown of the season and thrown for his first touchdown of his career. And he puts the hometown team up 21-0 in an important interconference clash with the SEC as Georgia Tech leads Mississippi State. Let's go to the sidelines, and Mike Hogwood has Paul Johnson.
First of all, Coach, what about your defense and what they have done when the other team gets in the red zone?
Well, we're good when they throw it to us, but we didn't do much in between. They drove the ball up and down the field.
One quick question. Jabo Shaw, your freshman, did he surprise you at all with the cool and calmness he's been running this offense?
Well, he's done some good things. He can hopefully he'll get better in the second half, too.
Right. Well, he's up 21-0, but you heard it. There's room for improvement, according to Paul Johnson. We're at halftime here in Atlanta.
Georgia Tech leads Mississippi State 21-0. 3 key turnovers for the Bulldogs in the first half. Standing by with Coach Sylvester Kroom is our Mike Hogwood.
Coach, what did you tell those guys in the locker room?
I told them we didn't play well in the first half. We had some opportunities. We got to come out and play one play at a time and not worry about the first half. It's over with now. Now we got 30 minutes. We got to get one more than they got.
All right. That's the word from Sylvester Kroom, Steve.
Thank you very much, Mike Hogwood. ACC football presented in high definition where available by MFS Investment Management, a diverse range of products so advisors can choose what fits. Georgia Tech to kick off. There's Derek Pegues back to receive for Mississippi State. And Scott Blair kicks it off for Georgia Tech. Leaves it a little bit short. It'll be picked up at the 18-yard line and returned out to the 33 by Zach Smith. It'll be first and 10 for Mississippi State. All right. tonight, Doc, how does Mississippi State improve on their first half performance?
Well, they've got to stop hurting themselves with the obvious turnovers, the interceptions. They can run. They ran the ball pretty well. I'm really impressed with what Wesley Carroll showed us. He can throw the ball. He's got to get some help from his receivers. It's just not good enough when you're down 21 to nothing to play catch. They got to break some tackles and get some yards after the catch.
Carroll, 11 of 17, but two picks. Robert Elliott is back with him. Hand off to Elliott coming left. And Michael Johnson. Actually, this is strange. Michael Johnson just got his first tackle of the day. Can you imagine that? He's had a blocked a field goal, three quarterback pressures. He's recovered a fumble. That's his first tackle of the day.
Well, I'm still trying to figure out why they keep trying to run his way. I think I might have a check with me at the line of scrimmage. Run away from 93.
That goes to show you the tackles may be an overblown statistic. He's done so much more. Second down and eight after the game of two. The throw deflected, and I think it might have been Richard. Or Walker. Deflected one of those two big defensive tackles for Georgia Tech.
Yeah, he actually dropped off. And this is the toughest thing. Coach Kroom at halftime is most good coaches telling the kids, hey, forget about it. Let's get out here, get a good drive. The worst thing that can happen is three and punt.
Third down and eight. Mississippi State, 4 of 7 on third. Our first and 10 line brought to you by SeatExchange.com, the official ticket exchange partner of the ACC.
I need McCray to come up with a big play.
Anthony Dixon back in the backfield. Here is Carroll to throw. Has time. Has a man out there. McCray. It is complete. As called for by Doc Walker at the 50-yard line. It's a gain on the play of 17. And the tackle.
I mean, you can only go so long before you cash in if you're going to do something. And McCray's got that kind of talent. You need all the guys that can make plays, your playmakers. Runs a good route, good push, comes out of the break. Ball is there, and you get upfield. That's the way it's done.
First big passing play in the Mississippi State offense this afternoon of 17 yards. First and 10 in Georgia Tech territory at the 49. Carroll, short drop. That might have been tip two. McCray has it. And is marked out about shy of the first down at the 41-yard line.
You know, we've talked so much about these defensive ends. This time, you watch Salisbury, right, get the cut down. Got those ends and get those hands down. And that time, Quentin does a pretty good job. Take a look at it. Again, you've got this He-Man. There's a leap. Get him out of there. Get him to turn. Get those hands out of the way. Quentin Salisbury, he's been in a war today.
Yes, he has. Second down and two. Draw play. Comes to Dixon, and he's got the first down. It's at the Georgia Tech 38-yard line. Short game by Dixon.
And I'll say this about Quentin, too, because as a redshirt freshman, about 285 pounds, 86 pounds. See, he still got a lot of fight in him. And when you're that young, going up against a guy who will play on Sunday, every Sunday, you know, that's quite a task. And they continue to leave the man up, and he's fighting.
First down. After 38, it's the 10th first down of the day for Mississippi State, who could only gain six of those last week. Here's the pass by Carroll, but he's pressured by Shane Bowen, who blitzed that time and put some pressure on the junior out of Pickerington, Ohio. Mississippi State in the first half, not too successful. They fumbled the ball on the first time they got the ball. That was punched in for a touchdown. Had a field goal block. Gave up on downs and had two interceptions. We have not seen the punter today. And Sylvester Kroom said, I wish we could have seen maybe one of those.
Well, once again, they sustained the drive. They're moving the chains. They just got to cash in.
Second down and 10. Out of the shotgun. Here's the pitch. It goes to Decree. Decree cuts inside, and that wasn't good. Because Walker was there along with Jasper and Griffin to stop it.
Well, when you go against Georgia Tech's offense in practice every day, I mean, you don't start quivering when you see the little option. Look at the outside-in relationship. See, even Walker, the defensive tackle, made sure he kept everything on his inside shoulder. Chambers, inside shoulder. That's guys that Coach Womack, he'll be tickled to death in the field study when he goes back and see the technique leads you to success.
Seventh play of the drive, 3rd and 9 for Mississippi State, down 21-0. They're 5 of 8 on third down. At the Georgia Tech 37. Carroll to throw, nice pocket pass complete behind McCray, and that allowed the DBs to get up. And Michael Johnson comes up with another tackle along with Morgan Burnett.
Man, he got
shy of the first down.
Steve, he got some help in the backfield that time, my friend.
Yep.
Yes, indeed.
Nice pocket.
Well, you know, if you're going to play this game, you got to fight back. Left side coming up. No, we didn't catch it on that. Maybe we'll get on the wide angle. Let you see a little lumber being thrown.
Now, if the ball had been thrown ahead of McCray,
he might have gotten Great point.
Field goal. Right. Adam Carlson on the field goal attempt. It's a 51-yarder. His career long is 48. It's a fake, and it's going to be a punt.
Pooch punt.
Now, this is the worst field position of the afternoon for Georgia Tech as they'll pick it up at their own 11, maybe the 12-yard line. So a pooch kick on a fake field goal. And Mississippi State gives the ball up after a 21-yard quick kick. 1st and 10 for Georgia Tech, up 21-0. ACC football brought to you in part by your local Toyota dealers. Toyota's keys are featured on RaycomSports.com. Javo Shaw comes out and brings the Yellow Jackets out in their worst field position of the day, their own 12-yard line. 1st and 10 after the punt by Mississippi State. They lead it 21-0. Shaw on the option. Here's Dwyer kicking it into a new speed. Dwyer ahead of the field, directs his blockers, turns the corner. Can anybody get him? No! Touchdown, Georgia Tech! 88 yards, no flag!
Johnson, and this spread offense is dangerous. Starts in the middle, but forget the block down. Then you get on the edge. Then you get guys where the lane will come up. Watch it right there. We're going to kind of get inside. Real smart out here. No clip. Staying up all the way down. You got to use your mind in this game. And Peoples, good thinking for a freshman.
Also, Lucas Cox in on a key block. Everybody had a chance. Roddy Jones did one. Here's Blair for the point after. It is good. And Georgia Tech sits the Mississippi State fans down on the far sideline. Jonathan Dwyer takes the pitch from Jabo Shaw and goes 88 yards for a score. And we have a flag down here on the play. Let's see what the discussion is. There's Dwyer getting the ice to the head after the long trot. We have an SEC crew working our game here today.
After the play was over, personal foul, number 94 on the defense. That tells me it's best on the kickoff.
Timeout after the Jonathan Dwyer 88-yard touchdown run. It puts Georgia Tech up 28-0. S&K Menswear is the official wardrobe provider for our ACC football broadcast team. Log on to SNKMenswear.com or stop in to save 40% on suits, dress shirts, and sportswear. Longest run from scrimmage in Georgia Tech history by that man, Jonathan Dwyer, the sophomore from Marietta, Georgia, for a score, the 4th Georgia Tech score of the day, 28-0. And after the penalty, personal foul after it's kicked out of the end zone easily there by Scott Blair. And Mississippi State is going to take over 1st and 10. Hey, if you're with us at the top of the broadcast, you saw one of the hottest acts in music, Rascal Flatts, performing their song, Bob That Head, from the album Still Feels Good. Hey, fans, you want to see a great show? Check out the Rascal Flatts on tour. For a complete concert listing, you go to www.rascalflatts.com. But you see they're going to be in Detroit tonight, Tulsa, Oklahoma, Bossier City, Louisiana, also coming up as well. And a new quarterback, Tyson Lee, is back at quarterback, and he's scrambling for his life. What a way to start. Jason Peters, part of a growing defensive line, along with Darryl Richard, a -4.
Well, they said to Mr. Lee, welcome to the ACC.
And that's the welcoming party.
This is his second activity. He's 12 for 18, 72%, 112 yards. This young man's from Columbus, Mississippi. He's a junior. And those are his numbers, as we said, on the season. He's facing second and 14. And off goes to Dixon. Anthony Dixon uses the umpire as a shield, but
he can slither his way through.
Travis Chambers helps out on the tackle.
Having been down 28 to nothing, it is a really lonely position to be in. But if you get one score right now, based on how much time is left, you know, you got to feel like you have a chance to do something. If you don't, you can stick a fork in it.
Third down, seven. Tyson Lee back to throw. Blitz is on. Pass complete, but for a loss on the play. Dixon catches the ball. Michael Johnson catches Tyson Lee.
When Dave Womack, coordinator, grades his film, you know, coaches will find fault in perfection. But what is he going to say to these kids? I mean, they're on the money. There's pressure, good tackling, they're breaking on the ball. And Georgia Tech is very good on defense.
First punt of the day by Blake McAdams. Calling for the fair catch is going to be Tyler Melton, the true freshman. And Georgia Tech, impressive on a 44-yard punt. They'll take the ball over with no return at the 35-yard line. Go to RaycomSports.com for a variety of ACC football highlights and features, archived videos, sweepstakes, podcasts, and information on our ACC Game of the Week. RaycomSports.com, your link on the web to the ACC. Our Game of the Week next week will come away from Clemson. The Maryland Terrapins taking on the Clemson Tigers. 12 noon on many of these same stations, Eastern Time. First and 10. Jabo Shaw under center. Comes the handoff. It goes to Dwyer. Dwyer breaking tackles into the secondary. He's on his horse again. And K.J. Wright gets him up around the head and drives him out of bounds. Multiple flags fly along the Mississippi State sideline. A 37-yard pickup by Jonathan Dwyer, who on two plays is over the century mark.
Yeah, and you can't lose your cool if you're a Bulldog. Tyler Melton, good job tying up your man. You put about 14 yards on that run as a receiver.
Personal foul. Unnecessary reference, late hit out of bounds. Number 34 on the defense. That penalty is half the distance to the goal. Automatic first down.
I mean, K.J. Wright, I mean, he's a good football player. But right now, they're just getting it. They're getting handled. Maneuvered upon. There you're going to see Melton. He gets an effort. That's another 13, 14 yards. And at this point here, I mean, you're out of bounds. And that push at the end is just not going to help your football team. And you're better than that.
First and 10 from the 14-yard line. The penalty marked off half the distance to the end zone after the 37-yard gain by Dwyer. Quincy Kelly is the lone setback. Dave O'Shaw hands off. No, he's got it. Shaw headed inside the five, and he's brought down. We got a couple of close horse callers here down to the 3-yard line. K.J. Wright.
Well, that's where you want to take your frustration out. You know, during the play, when the ball snapped, then you got a chance to have a 6-second fit.
All right, let's take a look. This is the fifth journey into the red zone here.
You know, Charles Burns came down real hard down the line, just didn't get there in time. And Jabo Shaw, he can play.
First and goal. I'll
tell you what,
he sure can. He's playing in place of the injured Josh Nesbitt, who tweaked a hamstring in the first half. Here's Jabo Shaw into the end zone for the touchdown. And Georgia Tech is painting them up now. Jabo Shaw's second touchdown run of the day. And third of the year, but is there a flag down? Yes, there is a flag down right at the two.
Good movement.
This may be coming back.
Personal foul. Chop block. Number 70 on the offense. That penalty is 15 yards from the previous spot. Replay first down.
So it is no touchdown. Roll the points off the board. And Georgia Tech will be first and goal from the 17-yard line.
I'm in favor of the rules committees in their attempt to preserve guys and not have ACLs. And, you know, the cut blocking, you know, that can take you out. And sometimes you don't even see it.
There goes Shaw in the air today, 3 of 4 on a touchdown. Got Melton to the top and Thomas to the bottom. Shaw, options.
Ooh, boys.
To the 14-yard line.
That pitch would have been in the end zone. He looks comfortable.
Here's what happened to Josh Nesbitt. After 151 yards, he pulls up limp. And that usually, when you grab the back of your leg, you're looking at a hamstring.
It's a two-weeker there.
You think?
That's a two-weeker. Unless it's a cramp, it's a two-weeker.
Well, for Georgia Tech, they got an off week next week, and then they play Duke in 2 weeks here.
Yeah, because if you want to have it healed so he can do what he does.
Second and goal from the 13. And off goes to Quincy Kelly, not much, if anything.
Surprised
into Kyle Love.
Surprised you didn't ask me if I stayed at a Holiday Inn last night. Because I was giving medical advice. Great commercial. I love it.
I'm telling you. The guy, guy says, I'm a doctor.
I'm a doctor. Again.
No. Did anybody say
it? Anybody
First and goal. A third and goal, actually, and it's from the 12-yard line here for Georgia Tech. Pushed back by the penalty, the chop block penalty. Shot a throw over the middle, almost picked off. Fitzhugh was there, went through his hands. It was intended for Demaryius Thomas.
Friendly fire on that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Quentin. Oh, yeah, runs right. Cox, I thought that maybe Cox was going to get a shot at running the football. Boy, that's a great camera angle. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I think he had it.
Jasper O'Quinn ran right into it. Fitzhugh, he got his bell rung a little bit. Now we got a player down again for Georgia Tech, Dan Voss, for the second time today, and it's going to be a shoulder. Fitzhugh was rung up around the head, and he ran into his own man in the end zone. And let's go to the sidelines, and one man who could sort this all out is Mike Hogwa.
I'm not sure about that. But
where'd you stay last night?
Same place you did.
Yeah,
I can tell you about Dan Voss, and Doc, you've seen this happen in football a lot. You get that stinger, and it was really bad. It went away. He came in and play, and then, boy, it just happens again, and, man, it is painful.
29-yard field goal attempt is going to be the result here. Once Voss clears the field, we may see Andrew Faulkner for the rest of the day. With Georgia Tech up here at 28-0 and threatening to put three more on out of the hold of Chandler Anderson. Blair, so far this season, is 2 for 6, his longest is 32. This is a 29-yarder. It is up. And it is good. Georgia Tech adds to their lead. Scott Blair with his third field goal of the season. And the Yellow Jackets are up 31-0 in this matchup between the SEC and the ACC today. That's been all ACC this afternoon. All season long, Champion Apparel will be showcasing the tradition and history of the ACC. Today, we highlight a big piece of Georgia Tech tradition. It's the Ramblin' Wreck, a 1930 Model A Ford sports coupe embodying the spirit, tradition, and the passion of Georgia Tech student body. The Wreck is presented at all major sporting events and student body functions since 1961. Its most noticeable role has been leading the football team on the Bobby Dodd Stadium at historic Grant Field. And that's our champion, How You Play. Jonathan Dwyer's had a big afternoon in the second half in particular. There's the pass. This is in the first half as he heads for the end zone or gets close to it. And here's the big run of 88 yards. Another run of 37.
Now this kid went 100 meters second rather than the state. Some guys are track guys. Some guys are football guys that are fast. He's both. And when you look at 230 pounds, he can change direction. He's got balance. All of that equals up to Rolls Royce.
9 runs, 141 yards. His third 100-yard day of the season in 4 games. Blair to kick it off. Pegues back deep. It's a short kick. Pegues at the 11. And he is hit. Blackwood and others. Well, when you're tailgating, Chick-fil-A is what you need. Chick-fil-A chicken strips all over the place. New flavor, larger and more tender. Try them in the new signature sauce. Now, the fans here at Georgia Tech are enjoying them. Available in 3 or 4 count for adults, 1 or 2 for the kids. And our Chick-fil-A nugget of the game. Of 110 players on the Georgia Tech roster, 75 either freshmen or sophomores. 14 of 22 of those have started, and those young men have been accountable for most, if not all, of the scores. Play action, Tyson Lee. The pass is complete to McCray, and he's hauled down by Jahewer Daniels for a first down at the 36-yard line. It's a gain of 12 for Mississippi State.
I think we could really enhance this Chick-fil-A, the whole sponsorship, if we had Chick-fil-A in the booth.
Well, yeah.
You know, I really think, I'm just a suggestion. You know, I'm just trying to help the company.
The company, I hope, hears. We can, I think we can show our tailgating skills. You saw Paul Johnson, head coach of the Yellow Jackets, and he's quite a stir in this town. And Vance Walker stirs Tyson Lee to the ground at the 31 for a loss of 5.
I just like good players who are fundamentally sound. And these kids aren't freelancing. I mean, they're looking at him, shoulder square, right where he's supposed to be, doing what he's supposed to do, and taking advantage of film study, all the things that a lot of people don't like to do. It's very obvious and evident, rather, when you see it done the right way.
Second down and 15. It's a big day for Georgia Tech recruits. You get a lot of them here on campus, and they've got to be impressed with what they see out of this program. Brandon McCray catches a short pass, a gain of about 3. Tackle made by Jahewer Daniels.
Steve, are you sure? I thought the Atlanta Falcons were doing a walkthrough here. Well, I thought they were decided to watch the game.
There's some big guys.
That's the biggest
there.
People in the world. Those kids can't be 17. I thought the Falcons were over here. Oh. Just watching.
Mississippi State faced with a 3rd and 12. They've gone in reverse. Jamail Smith is to the top, to the bottom, Brandon McCray, and in the slot is Aubrey Bell. Bulldogs trailing by 31. Out in the flats, Lee throws a bullet, and it's incomplete through the hands of Aubrey Bell. Now that brings out the punter for the second time today.
I like Lee. He's showing me something. I mean, could have been potential decapitation. He gets out of it. Throws it right on the money. He needs a help. He needs a playmaker. Got to make a play.
Yeah, that's got to be the play that's made. Here comes the kick by McAdams. And Georgia Tech will try to get away from this. It's a short kick. And it comes to rest at the 33-yard line. A 33-yard punt, no return. Georgia Tech has the ball when we come back up 31. Back after this word from your local station. Third quarter, Georgia Tech, an impressive 31-0 count on Mississippi State, and the Yellow Jackets have the ball again after the 33-yard punt. First and 10 at their own 34-yard line. Gabe O'Shaw still under center. Andrew Faulkner is that center. Back to throw. Here's Shaw. Has some time. And it is incomplete. He overthrew. Looks like Embry Peoples.
That's...
When you look at Paul Johnson, now just think about this. Mississippi State held Auburn to 315 yards. Already, Paul Johnson's offense rolled up 344. Now, Auburn is the 10th-ranked team in the country. Now, what's this mean ahead for Georgia Tech if they can come up here, pitch the shutout?
Yeah, but what are early rankings? I mean, let's be fake. Be serious.
That's true.
You might as well close your eyes and pick teams. Nobody knows what the heck's going on unless you start playing good teams.
Well, Mississippi State found themselves playing a good team here this afternoon. And Jabo Shaw does an excellent play fake to Jonathan Dwyer and carries himself to a 15-yard gain. out near the midfield at the 49. Let's bring in Mike Hogwood.
Well, you know, you talk about J-Bo Shaw, a true freshman, but he's been running this offense his whole life. His dad is a high school coach, and that high school, Flowery Branch in Georgia, runs this exact offense that Paul Johnson does. And I even understand that there's another Shaw coming up who's a pretty good quarterback at Flowery Branch playing for dad.
Wow. That's a talent pipeline. Wonder where he's going.
I can give you a couple choices.
Three-step drop goes to Thomas, but it's out of bounds.
Pass is incomplete.
Stops the clock with 4:30 left here in the third.
What's good for Paul Johnson's offense is that they can work on things now and in the air game. And they can, you mentioned the bye week, they've got Duke, and Duke is really playing some pretty good football. But as this team adds more in its arsenal, especially from an aerial attack, they're going to be a really good team.
Well, that's the next step that Paul wants to take. And he bristles when he says, well, you're just nothing but a, you know, grind it out, triple option team. He said, no, we want to throw the football. And on occasions they've done it and done it with success. Here comes Roddy Jones and takes the
That should be a penalty.
And there is a flag down there.
Yeah, this Faulkner, who came in at the end, and can't impress upon young people enough, play up to the whistle and then that's it.
Yeah, this one's going to be against
after
Georgia
the play
Tech.
Was over. Personal foul, late hit number 65 on the offense. That penalty is 15 yards from the end of the run. Third down.
So wipes out the 6-yard gain, and it is third down and 19 for the Yellow Jackets.
Yeah, it's controlled violence. You know, it's just not hooligans. You play up to the whistle, you stop.
They piled up 8 penalties last week against Virginia Tech. So that's a concern of Paul's at this point in time. Ball security and the plays in which you beat yourself. Shaw with a handle. Nice pitch late to Peoples. And driven out of bounds there.
Number 24,
Tate Bowser, the junior from Gilmer, Texas.
He's forced out of bounds by number 28.
At every point of attack, Mississippi State played it very well. It's just the benefit of this option.
And Shaw executes it very well. I mean, he's...
Yeah. Well, my Hogwood's points are well taken.
Yeah.
Because this kid, can you teach someone how to be this... this advanced in it at that young age?
I don't think so. He's running it like he's a senior. Going for it on fourth down. Fourth down and 6.
And oh, love the movement.
Yeah, they're trying to
bait you.
Yeah, they're baiting Mississippi State to come offside.
They put two worms on that hook.
They brought both A-backs in next to the B-back, and we'll see the punter here probably in all likelihood. And you're sitting there going, why go for it? Why go for it? Why not take a free one? This football season, it's all about you, 10 friends, and a private jet. Wow. Enter the Alltel My Circle Gridiron giveaway for your chance to take 10 friends on a private jet. You can call it your own to any regular season game. The ultimate VIP experience. For your chance to win, text ACC to 57533 or visit AllTelFootball.com. Wow.
That'd be a nice trip, my friend.
You gotta find the 10 friends.
You don't have to fill the plane up, do you?
Be
more food. Go with 8.
That's a good way to look at it.
If it's stocked for 10, we take 8.
My Chandler Anderson will come in and punt this. This will be his first kick. He's a true freshman from Columbus, Georgia. Where our pregame show producer, Beverly Rummey, is from. Oh, beautiful kick. This guy can really kick. They were worried about whether or not he might get a case of the nerves here in his first college football game. You know, matter of fact, in Boston, they were just going to, by chance, just send him out. Just all of a sudden, fourth down, they just tug on his jersey. You go out. You go out and kick it.
That's one way to minimize the jitters.
But I tell you what, this kid holds for Scott Blair, and there's probably no more important job than that. You get the jitters there. Paul Johnson talking to him, hey, you got to drop it inside the one. He got a 47, 46-yard punt, but it'll come out to the 20 on the touchback. 3.5 left in the third. Tyson Lee, draw play to Elliott. And Elliott picks up some nice yardage. He'll get out to the 34-yard line. It'll be a 14-yard gain for the Bulldogs. They're better running plays of the day. Matter of fact,
they've had three or four times that they've been able to come down and get a good downhill run going. The problem has been sustaining.
Yep, Georgia Tech has done a great job of corralling that offense. They've only given up three what we would call big plays. A 71-yard run, gave up a 17-yard pass, and that 14-yard run there. Lee, pass complete. Oh, nice move by Aubrey Bell. And he moves it out to the 48-yard line. It's going to be a 14-yard gain for Mississippi State.
Boy, did they need that.
Oh, yes.
Somebody do something after the catch. They've been proficient in throwing the catch, but you had to do more. And this time you're able to, shake Reed and get a little more. And every guy's got to have that contribution.
Aubrey Bell on the reception. One career touchdown to his credit. First down, Tyson Lee pulls it out. Now he's going to run it. And a nice tackle there by Shane Bowen. A shoestringer, but not before Tyson Lee's gained 7 yards.
That defensive front for Georgia Tech that we've talked a lot about, man, you talk about licking your chops. This is, they're thinking stats now. They've got to throw, they got to get their way back into it, and we can pick up the numbers.
Well, let's take a look at our O'Reilly Down and Distance. Better parts, better prices every day. Second down and 3 for the Bulldogs. And in Georgia Tech territory, Robert Elliott gets the call. And Elliott gets the first down at the 40-yard line. It's going to be a gain of 4. Cedric Griffin in on the tackle. Mississippi State next week. They're at LSU. Then they have Vanderbilt at home. Then they're at Tennessee. Georgia Tech has an off week next week, and then they take on Duke and Gardner-Webb here before they go for a big showdown at Clemson.
Well, they can take their frustration out on the Tigers, huh?
Yeah. 4-yard gain brings up 1st and 10. Lee. Pass complete to Dupree, and Dupree is inside the 20. And the first red zone incursion by the Mississippi State Bulldogs in the second half. Page in on the tackle for Georgia Tech. It's a 24-yard gain on the pass hookup.
Well, no doubt we've seen pieces of it. Salisbury does a pretty good job this time. Keeps those ends off his quarterback. And then you see Dupree knows how to get the ball upfield.
Fifth play of the drive that started at the Mississippi State 20. 1st and 10 from the Georgia Tech 15, 17. And we've got all kinds of problems here. A flag on the play. We've got several players moving at the snap from Mississippi State, so this will be brought back.
Prior to the snap, false start. Number 75 on the offense. That penalty is 5 yards from the previous spot. Replay first down.
And that pushes him back to the 21-yard line. Closing in on the end of the third quarter here. 1st and 15 for Mississippi State. Trying to get one on the board here in the third quarter. In a game which they've been manhandling most of the way. Bell and McCray are the wideouts. Poirot Riley to the other side. Tyson Lee on a five-step brought. Wants Riley. And actually Elliott, and it's incomplete.
Man, they had a free runner. I mean, the constant pressure. Good job with the interior. You leave a man like Reed unblocked. You got to check so the receiver's hot. Held the ball too long. You got to get out of that. As soon as you see your back, Elliott in this case, disengaged, if you get the ball up, then score.
2nd and 15. Ball at the 21. Lee with time as a man there. What a catch, but it's ruled incomplete. One-arm grab by Brandon McCray. Brings up third down.
Man, they're close. They can't finish it. That's a super effort. There's nothing they can do because he's trying to, I mean, you got an awkward fall. Just don't know what to do on that one. And then Jasper, man, with the hit. My goodness. That was, woo!
Third down.
Lumber.
Third down and 15. Georgia Tech leading 31-0. Mississippi with the ball. They're 1 of 4 third down conversions in the second half. Lee with time. Johnson chases him out of the pocket. Looks at the other half. He sees Walker.
It's a video game now.
Pass out there. Complete. And that's Dupree, the backup running back.
He may have it. He may have it.
He's close. Let's see where forward progress is. Jasper makes the tackle. Boy, they had Tyson Lee bottled up, but he got out of it.
Well, if I'm Coach Kroom, I'm looking, you know, forget the scoreboard. I see my people still fighting. You know, still fighting. Here's Lee. He's got a feel for it.
Oh, yeah.
And you know Johnson said, I got another one. I'm close. And those linemen, this is a chance for them to tee off. Ball right on the money. Now, this is like watch the green.
Fourth down and one. And now Mississippi State will call timeout, but will they beat the quarter? That's the thing. The quarter has come to an end, and it looks like that's where we'll start the next chapter here with Mississippi State, fourth down and one, going for it inside the 10 down to the 7-yard line. They need about the 6.5.
There's no timeout charged to Mississippi State. The quarter ended prior to the quarterback calling timeout. That is the end of the quarter.
Good description by Hubert Owens, and we'll take a break with him. Through three in Atlanta, it's Georgia Tech. Jonathan Dwyer on his way to a 150-yard day leads the Yellow Jackets to a 31-0 lead. Welcome back to Atlanta. Steve Martin, Rick Doc Walker, Mike Hogwood. We start the fourth and one. Georgia Tech up 31-0, but Mississippi State threatening. Tyson Lee, the Bulldog quarterback. Rolls out of the grass, and now will go down. Second tackle, second sack for Michael Johnson. And the third time today that Mississippi State gives up on downs.
I saw James Shaq Harris, the former Grambling All-American, fourth Pro Bowler, who's scouting and working with Jacksonville, the Jaguars, and they're in the executive position. And I said, what about this kid? Just smile. If you're an NFL guy, how do you not like this? Agility, speed, tenacity, he's got it all, the whole package. Michael Johnson.
Well, we've seen this Yellow Jacket team chew up yardage despite the loss of their starting quarterback, Josh Nesbitt, today, and their starting center, who was injured twice with stings. First and 10 from the 13. Dave Shaw pitches late to Roddie Jones, and he is upended by Jasper O'Quinn.
Man, you got to have help from your wideouts. When you're catching that toss blind, that's a blind toss. You got to have faith in it happening. Man.
Still a 7-yard gain, Doc.
Yeah, but the 7 yards, you don't want to take that kind of hit for just 7 yards. I'm going to tell you that right now. When you get back to your wideouts, man, you're going to grab Claiborne by and say, yo, dog, you got to hook me up better than that.
John Bedford is the new center now. Third one of the day they've used. This is Quincy Kelly, and he gets the first down and more out to the 26-yard line. Tackled by Jamon Clanton. And it's going to be another first down for the Yellow Jackets, who have gained 15 of them today. First and 10, Georgia Tech off next week. They have Duke in the week after, then Gardner-Webb. And then a big showdown that all of a sudden is looking big for both teams now. Clemson and Georgia Tech on the 18th. Shaw. Peoples, and he's brought down by Derek McGee's at the 34-yard line. Gain on the play of about 9. So Georgia Tech continues to chew up yardage. Our statue's new quarter is presented by the new AT&T, and it proves us that. 321 yards on the ground, and you're right, Doc, no
turnovers. No turnovers. Boy, Zach Fisher had an outstanding effort blocking on that particular play.
Second down and one. Jabo Shaw, long count, hand off Kelly, and Kelly is wrestled there by Clinton, and he pushes ahead for the first down of the 39. Clinton tried to lift and Mitchell tried to help, but all they did was help him off the ground so he could get some more traction.
Coach Johnson talked this week about what he's looking for his club, and it's the effort to play all the way to the whistle. You know, he wanted them to play every play as if it's their last play, all the way to the whistle. And those were things, traits indicative of the midshipmen when you saw Navy play. And I'm seeing things happening right now here in the fourth quarter that the Yellow Jackets have caught on.
First and 10 after the four-yard gain. Pitch to the flats to Peoples. He'll turn the corner and get driven out of bounds. But it's, again, it's a six-yard gain on the play. They're averaging almost 9 yards a play.
Charles Byrd for the Bulldogs shows you a big fella can run. He ran that play down from his tackle spot.
Second down coming after the 8-yard gain. Georgia Tech, they have the, it's interesting, we were in their team room yesterday. They have their 5-season goals listed. We'll talk about them here in a moment. Mm-hmm. And off goes inside. And that's Quincy Kelly again. He's been a featured back on this drive, and he pushes the ball into Mississippi State territory at the 46. K.J. Wright, Derek McGee's come up on the tackle. One of their goals on the season is to be top 10 rushing offense and top 10 rushing defense in the country. And they've taken a major step in the rushing offense.
They're in the hunt.
They are.
They're in the hunt.
First and 10. Garside is in the backfield. Ooh, that's Quincy Kelly again, and Cortez McCraney would have none of it.
That's a clinic there. You talk about how to attack the option. And that time they got it. Unfortunately, not enough.
Yeah. Hey, Georgia Tech's begun league play away from home. They upset Boston College, lost narrowly to Virginia Tech in the last minute of the week ago. With four of their six remaining conference games at home, can the Yellow Jackets make it to Tampa in the ACC Football Championship December 6th? Their journey on the road to Tampa Bay continues in 2 weeks. They host Duke. And that's now looming as a bigger game than people thought. The Blue Devils playing as well as they have. Pitch to the corner goes to Greg Smith. Smith down the sideline. It's open. Smith all the way. End zone. Touchdown.
Must be an awesome feeling to be that fast. I was talking to Robert Smith, former Ohio State Buckeye, Minnesota Viking. I just asked him, what is it like? Because he had a lot of great long runs. He said, there's nothing like it. When you know that the people have an angle on you and they can't catch it, this is one of those examples. Feet inside the mitts, good pitch, great execution by Shaw. And right now, you just know that you can't be touched.
Here comes Blair for the point after. It is good. And Georgia Tech tacks another one on. This one a long strike from 45 yards. Greg Smith into the end zone for his first rushing touchdown of the year. And Georgia Tech keeps moving on. Up 38-0 on Mississippi State. Today's game is brought to you in part by O'Reilly Auto Parts, better prices every day. Scott Blair getting ready to kick it away. And there's Greg Smith. Scored the touchdown, his fifth career touchdown. He's a junior out of Atlanta, Georgia, here in his hometown. McGee's picks this one up at the four. McGee's headed to the sideline, trying to make something happen, and he is going to be finally pulled out of bounds on the second try by the kicker. Zach Werdan was the first guy to hit him, but Scott Blair knocked him out of bounds. 47-yard kickoff return. We'll see it again.
Well, as advertised, McGee has a real good feel for this. Get some help up front, got outside, just ran out of real estate.
Now he's the leading all-time kickoff returner in Mississippi State history. And Mississippi State sets up at the Georgia Tech 49-yard line. This is their best field position of the day. They're trailing 38-0. Tyson Lee with time to throw. Pass is complete. And the ball pulled down by Brandon McCray. Let's go to the sidelines of Mike Hogwood.
We would all agree that Michael Johnson has really worked hard and had a great game. But, you know, in past years, he has kind of faltered a little bit in the fourth quarter. He asked his buddy, Tashard Choice, former running back here now with the Cowboys, what he should do. And Tashard says, I got some great advice from Emmitt Smith, and that is drink Pedialyte. Yeah, if you have kids, you know what that stuff is. Well, Michael Johnson started drinking the Pedialyte, and it worked. He's had four pretty strong quarters here today.
Pedialyte on the rocks for everybody. Tyson Lee back to throw. Chased out of the pocket.
Oh, man.
Oh, he stays in bounds. Takes a hard hit. Could have gone out of bounds at the 41, but picked up three extra yards, and he might be there for the first down. Matter of fact, he is. That second effort. Got the first down. Steven Sylvester comes up.
Yeah, Lee's very, I mean, he makes people miss.
He moves the chains.
But you have to realize there's a dump truck headed your way. You know, and sooner or later, you need to get down. Get what you need to do and get down, son.
With either 99, 95,
that's
or 93
right. One of those
on the side.
Yellow jackets.
Yep. First and 10, Mississippi State at the 37-yard line. Well, he's got time to throw, and throw he does, right at the cameraman on the sidelines.
Now, if you think that shutting Mississippi State out in the Big Ten, look how many of the Yellow Jackets are standing. You know, guys who played, who were into this thing. You can always tell the team's attitude by looking at his bench.
Yep.
So it means something. You want the goose egg.
And you got 9:19 to preserve it. And, of course, Sylvester Croom wants his team to get used to dancing in the end zone. Hasn't happened. They're in their second game without a score offensively. They got to go play LSU next week. Here's Lee. Pass is complete. It's McCray. Oh, really puts on the acceleration after the catch and gets down to the 18-yard line. Again, Steven Sylvester on the tackle. It's a 19-yard gain for Brandon McCray.
Now, a play here, a play there, Mississippi State has put pieces together. But the whole sum of it has been, you know, fumbled in the interception. It's been self-inflicted wounds. They have just got to play within themselves, cut out the mistakes, and they can be a good football team.
They've been run over here in the second half by Jonathan Dwyer and Greg Smith. Yeah. Long arms for touchdowns.
Yeah. Yeah, I hope they graduate.
Here's the pass. It is incomplete. Intended. On the wing there for Delman Robinson, who's a true freshman. Georgia Tech. You know, another one of those five goals that they've set for the season is to be undefeated at home. They've beaten Jacksonville State. They played two road games after that, and now here they are. Mississippi State's in the red zone, and let's take a look at what they've done. Three possessions. They've come up empty each time, had a field goal block, and gave the ball up on downs twice. That's a look at our O'Reilly Auto Parts. Red zone, better parts, better prices every day. Second and 10 from the 19. Tyson Lee passes complete to Elliott. Elliott breaks one tackle, but he won't get out of the grasp of number 46, Matt Camp. Makes the tackle. A 12-yard gain.
Pretty good pass protection on this one. And a lot of that is to do with Michael Johnson's on the bench right now, which is a good thing if you're a Bulldog fan. But you make a guy miss, you start moving it closer and closer. Now, they've been down here before and ended up with nothing.
Well, they blew themselves up the first two times. They blew themselves up with penalties. First and goal from the 6. Draw play, Elliott into the end zone. Touchdown. Mississippi State. So the shutout is averted.
Well, he's going to need to look at the scoreboard. Because you can't do a Deion Sanders down 48-0. 38-0, rather. That Deion Beale ain't working. That lets you leave. It's never too late to score. Nice block up front by Gates.
Here's Carlson for the point after. It is good. And Mississippi State is on the board, taking advantage of their best field position of the day, going seven plays and 49 yards to make it 38-7 Georgia Tech. Mississippi State gets on the board, but Georgia Tech continues to dominate 38-7 in this matchup between the ACC and the SEC in Atlanta. But coming into this game, the SEC had a 3-1 edge in games played between the two. This one caught by the up back, not even an up back. Number 73 for Georgia Tech, that's Austin Barrett. Look at the Hampton Hotel's upcoming schedule for Georgia Tech. They get a well-deserved week off. They'll be 3-1 headed into it. And they have Duke and Gardner-Webb here at home. And then a key game at Clemson in an intra-divisional game on the 18th. And then they have Virginia at home and Florida State at home. So they're in a stretch of 5 of 6 here at Bobby Dodd Stadium. New quarterback for Georgia Tech is Brian Dykes. He hands off to Quincy Kelly, who gets not much. So we're three deep in quarterbacks here this afternoon for the Yellow Jackets.
Well, that was my question. No doubt about it, DeJabo Shaw passed the test. But who's his backup? Josh could be out for a couple of weeks. Hopefully it's just a cramp. Sometimes you never know about these things, but it looked good when athletes stop running immediately and then start to limp. That looked good.
There's Bryce, redshirt freshman. Dykes as he moves the ball out over the 36, and he'll keep it on his own this time. It's wrapped up by Terrell Johnson. Look at what Paul Johnson has achieved. It's really amazing in his 11 years of coaching. He's going to roll up a career victory number 110, and look who he's in the company of. Most wins in the first 11 seasons. Tom Osborne, the only one who had more. And add 4 to that total right now. Barry Switzer, Bud Wilkinson, Steve Spurrier. That's pretty select company, Doc.
Well, you know, he's done it everywhere he's been.
And he's one of 14 head coaches in the Football Bowl Championship Series who calls his own plays, offensive coordinator. We have Quincy Kelly, who's the player down here. So as we sort out what happens there, timeout on the field, 7:15 left to play here in the fourth. Georgia Tech big on Mississippi State. Back in Atlanta, 3rd down and 4 coming up. O'Reilly down in distance, better parts, better prices every day. Georgia Tech now. A costly win for him. Nesbitt out with the hamstring. And Quincy Kelly just went to the sidelines. Bryce Dyke still has the ball, and he pushes ahead in that second effort. They have gotten the first down at the 48-yard line. Gain of 6 yards for Bryce Dykes.
Dykes come in late. He want to keep drives alive. Second time he's run with the football. On the mesh there, he's got it tucked, so he intended to run. There was no pitch in mind.
Tell you what, the off week is going to come as a big relief here to Georgia Tech with Dan Voss injured, their center. They're using their 3rd center of the day, their 3rd quarterback of the day. And they lost the backup B-back. This is Greg Smith, who went 45 yards for a touchdown last time. We got a flag down on the play. Walk down a bounds, a yard shy of the first down. This may be coming back.
Well, he's left it now.
Georgia Tech, an explosive offense. Here's a stat for you. 28 plays of 20 yards or more through now the first 4 games of the season. That is impressive.
Very much so.
And you say this is a ground-based offense.
Number 33 on the offense. That penalty is declined. Personal foul. Clipping. Number 74 on the offense. That penalty is 15 yards from the previous spot. Replay first down.
So some mistakes here by Georgia Tech in the late going. This will back them up to their own 33-yard line. It'll be 1st and 25. Bryce Dykes. I don't think Paul Johnson wanted to see what Bryce has for throwing on. The rushing yards today, 420. It's the 10th best all-time total in Georgia Tech history. 263 yards they average. So they'll blow that average up quite a bit as a result of today's activity against a defense that usually doesn't give much. And the quarterback Dykes goes down And in the grasp of LaMarcus Williams, a sophomore from Bastrop, Louisiana. We have a timeout on the field. Timeout taken by Mississippi State with 6:04 left to go. Well, let's take a look at our principal financial players of the game. For Mississippi State, Brandon McCray, 10 receptions, a career high for 102 yards. And Jonathan Dwyer, an 88-yard run, the highlight of a day that sees him rush for 141 yards. It's the longest run from scrimmage by anyone, any position, longest in Georgia Tech history. He scored a touchdown today. It's his third day of 100 yards or more this season. There's Brandon McCray from Mississippi State, a bright spot in an otherwise very dark day. Very dark day for the Bulldogs, who had hoped to carry the banner of the SEC into Atlanta and come out with a win, but they could not.
Well, they carried it in. Then the ambush took place.
And there's Jonathan Dwyer. Great day for him. Calvin Booker is in at quarterback, fourth QB of the day. Booker upfield, pass is complete.
Nice strike.
And it's going to be complete to R.B. Clyburn. That's your freshman from Carterville, Georgia. It's a gain of 18. Another big play for Georgia Tech this afternoon and a day of big plays. 88-yard touchdown run, a 45-yard touchdown run. Here's Calvin Booker. And now we got a another timeout taken. And is this by Mississippi State? This is another Mississippi State timeout. Sylvester Croom wants another touchdown, I guess.
Can you blame
him? Well, let's go to the sidelines and Mike Hogwood.
Oh, Stephen, Doc, you may have noticed that Georgia Tech is wearing a little different uniform this year. First of all, they're wearing white jerseys for the first time since the George O'Leary era. But their pants are a little different, and they are a Russell Athletic school, just like Oregon is a Nike school, as far as testing different kinds of uniforms. The players came up with this along with Russell Athletic, and it's really also a different kind of gold. I kind of like the new unis. What do you guys think?
They're just a shade darker than they normally were. If you look quick, you think you're looking at LSU or something like that. Booker back to throw, steps up, and now carries on his own, and finally is brought down. And now Cortez McCrane is going to be whistled for a late hit. The legitimate tackle was Bo Walters, two freshmen out of Wilsonville, Alabama. And the other thing, Mike and Doc, I like about these uniforms, those
after
nice...
the play was over, personal foul, late hit, number 90 on the defense. 15 yards added to the end of the run. First down.
So that keeps the drive alive. I like the blue numerals. I think they're outstanding. There's the late hit by McCraney. For years, Georgia Tech wore those home white with the blue outline and the gold numbers, and it was crazy. You could hardly tell who you were looking at on the field. These uniforms are crisp. 8 on the rush, 15 on the penalty. Brings up 1st and 10 at Mississippi State territory. And the pass is incomplete. And it's intended for number 81. That's Zach Fisher. A lot of extra people here for Georgia Tech. And now Dykes comes back into the ballgame, and Booker comes to the sideline. Bryce Dykes. Other scores elsewhere around the country. Ohio State prevails over Troy. Ooh, a great one in Raleigh, tied up between the Wolfpack and the Pirates. And Bama running all over Arkansas. Clemson doing the same to South Carolina State. Here comes Bryce Dykes, and he is inside the 20 to the 19. Gain of 7 on the play, and Georgia Tech continues to roll up rushing yardage. Zach Smith on the tackle for Mississippi State.
Penn State, another real light contest. Although Temple has shown problems this year, but
You got Bobby Bowden and Joe Paterno in that race.
Yeah.
And they're gonna make sure if he plays somebody, I'll play somebody. Well, Bobby Bowden's team will play somebody tonight. They got Wake Forest at home. And if they come away with a win on that one, they'll be very fortunate indeed. It's gonna be Dykes on a carry for about a yard, and Carlin Brown in on the tackle. Next week we'll come your way from Clemson's Death Valley and bring you what should be an interesting Atlantic Division battle between the Clemson Tigers and the Maryland Terrapins. Georgia Tech threatens the red zone one more time. And let's take you inside the 20 in the red zone. Georgia Tech today, three possessions, two touchdowns and a field goal. So they're 100% so far today when they get inside here. Now, you say, well, what about the Dwyer run and what about Greg Smith run? They came from outside the red zone in. So they're not counted as official takes there. This is the measurement for first down. And it's first and 10 for the Yellow Jackets. That's a look at the O'Reilly Auto Parts red zone. Better parts, better prices every day. Paul Johnson's team serving notice to the country today. They are not only a force to be reckoned with in the ACC, but I think they're going to be a force to be reckoned with nationally.
Especially if that defense can continue to play at this level.
Well, the offense getting 450 yards rushing won't hurt even more.
But still, it comes down to can you get stops.
Dykes, the pitch is behind the intended back. And that is Malone. Jonathan Malone, a lead back out of Marietta, Georgia. He's a junior. Paul Johnson has had success with Georgia Southern. Under the national championship of what was then 1AA football five times. And then, of course, five straight bowl appearances with Navy after going 2-10 his first season. Loss of one on the play brings up second down and 11. And here's the keeper by Dykes, who regrets it immediately. Jimmy Holmes, the senior from Aiken, South Carolina, doing the damage, a loss of two. He's gone over the side. I said, what'd you call that for me, coach? So what? You're one of the 14.
Yeah, man. Other team has plans, too.
Calvin Booker's back into the ballgame here at quarterback as Paul Johnson not taking any chances. This is a passing situation, and this is his best thrower in the squad. Booker back on a five-step drop. Flushed once. Can he find someone? No. Tackle made on the play by Bo Walters. We have a flag down at about the 17-yard line. 3:08 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Pretty much know what the outcome is going to be. Let's take a look at our AP Top 25 and combine the two conferences that we're seeing here today. That'll be declined, by the way. Georgia, Florida, LSU, Alabama, and Auburn. The SEC representatives, Auburn playing LSU at Jordan-Hare today. Of course, Florida State and Wake Forest battling as 24 hosts 18, and then the Clemson Tigers will undoubtedly move up from their 23rd posting. They were as high as 9 prior to the Alabama game. All right, attempted field goal here. And this is going to be the third kicker we've seen in the game. The kick is out, and it is no good. Trying to get a beat on this man, Muhammad Yowie, the third kicker in the game for Georgia Tech. The 37-yard field goal attempt falls mute, and it goes first and 10 for Mississippi State.
Some days, no matter how much you put into this, it doesn't seem like it's fair. But it's the way it is.
That's the way it is.
Yeah, the way it is.
Now we got flags everywhere, but as Tyson Lee backs up in the backfield. That's Muhammad Yahiawi. Yeah, I was close.
Prior to the snap, substitution infraction on the defense. 5 yards from the previous spot. First down.
Our Polaris Ranger hardest working player of the game is Michael Johnson. One sack. One forced fumble, two passes defended, one blocked field goal, one recovered fumble, as a matter of fact, and a couple of tackles to boot. One of them on that sack. obviously. First and five after the penalty. Mississippi State. And here comes Elliott. And he dances up near the first down. How good has Michael Johnson been? Well, Doc, he's among the best, and he proved why today.
Up for the challenge, enthusiastic. Really like the special teams play. Showing you what kind of athlete he is.
Play comes back in. Pass is complete to Robinson, Delmon Robinson. Tyson Lee, as we take you through the final 2 minutes of this one, the clock moving right along. Mississippi State was exhausted two timeouts to get enough time to do what they're doing right now. The pass to the flats complete to Bell. He falls ahead at the 36. Four-yard gain. Mississippi State schedule doesn't let up, obviously. They go to another Death Valley, LSU. Baton Rouge on a Saturday night. I don't envy them. They have a timeout from Mississippi State, their final timeout. Then they have Vanderbilt at home. Then they're at Tennessee before they play Middle Tennessee State. But Rick Stockstill's team will not be an easy breather because he's got that team cranked up. So it's going to be now five tough tests in a row here for Mississippi State.
And that's when you respect what the job that Sylvester Croom and his staff have done in last season, earning SEC Coach of the Year. They don't give those out. The friendship.
And, you know, and there's some pretty good coaches in the SEC. Some guys have done some pretty good jobs. You know, the thing about Mississippi State, and Sylvester Croom told us this on Thursday, he said, yeah, we played well, we did all the things, but he thinks that his team forgot some of the sacrifices that they made last year in the early part of the season. They were stunned on the road at Louisiana Tech. They had five turnovers in that game. They struggled offensively last week against Auburn. Admittedly, a good offensive team. They go into overtime in Raleigh. As you look at scores around the country, no such fate here. It's Georgia Tech rolling up its third win. The only question is how much. Tyson Lee, the pass complete to Elliott. And if he's smart, he'll get himself out of bounds, but does not. They're out of timeouts. The clock will stay. Yeah, the clock continues to roll here. In the fourth quarter, after the 44-yard line, Michael Peterson makes the stop. Gain of 11. Moves the chains. But the clock moves in conjunction with it, and Mississippi State can do nothing to stop it. Lee back to throw. The blitz on.
Trouble.
And our flag comes down. The hit made by Albert Rocker. Albert Rocker on the rush and the tackle. But we got a flag down in the secondary. And that's an ineligible receiver downfield. Of course, let's see what the call is going to be official.
Ineligible receiver downfield, number 82, covered up on the line of scrimmage. That's 5 yards from the previous spot. Replay first down.
This is historic Grant Field at Bobby Dodd Stadium, and these two schools play in the oldest facilities in the football bowl championship. And this is underneath the stadium, the original Bobby Dodd Field. Grant Field has been preserved underneath the stanchions of what you see outside. And of course, Mississippi State plays in the second oldest. The pass out there, intended for Nelson Hurst, the tight end, the freshman, is incomplete. Stops the clock with a minute 17 to go. Of course, this stadium has been remade over several times. The most recent refurbishing came during the Olympics, which were held here in Atlanta. And Georgia Tech facilities were used quite liberally for the Olympics. It was a very big boon to this school. 55,000 seats here, and many of them were filled about 3 hours ago. And with this verdict pretty well determined, a lot of them have emptied out as the crowd want to enjoy the rest of their Saturday afternoon. Tyson Lee's pass. Oh, nearly a great one-handed catch by Brandon McRae, who's had himself a great day. Over 100 yards. I'll tell you what, this Georgia Tech team has been impressive. This is our second time seeing them. We saw them on the road at Boston College. Their offense was impressive, but their defense was outstanding, forcing three Eagle turnovers in the second half.
Yeah, they're light years away offensively from the first time we saw them.
Oh, 3 weeks.
Light years.
How many teams do you know could come in here, lose their quarterback on the ninth play of the game, and just go on and get even better with the two freshman backup. I mean, they got it going. People are excited about Paul Johnson. The pass to the flats to Jamail Smith is incomplete. Stops the clock with a minute four left to go. Georgia Tech 38, Mississippi State 7. The Yellow Jackets with an impressive victory. They scored the first time they got the ball, went 11 straight runs, and finished it off, and they have never looked back. Embry Peoples took that first pitch in. Demaryius Thomas caught a touchdown pass from Jabo Shaw, and they were on to the races. They got another score before halftime by Shaw again on a 25-yard keeper on fourth down. Fourth down and long now, Mississippi State. Lee, pass complete. Jamail Smith.
He may have that.
Stops the clock with just under a minute to go. It was 21-0 at the half in the third quarter. Dwyer just took all of the wind out of Mississippi State's sails with an 88-yard touchdown run. Then Blair added a 29-yard field goal. Greg Smith, a 45-yard run. And the only score by Mississippi State is a 6-yard run by Robert Elliott. Pass incomplete.
Well, you come out at halftime, and you know you've had a speech, rah-rah, you've hit a few lockers with your forehead. You come out, and you get a pretty decent drive, sustain a few yards, and you're going, and then you punt, and one play, boom, you're knocked out.
Yep.
Big run.
Yep, and that's what happened. An 88-yard run by Jonathan Dwyer just kind of ended this thing, and now we've just been waiting for the final verdict. 49 seconds left to play. Second down and 10. Tyson Lee passes. Aubrey Bell receives. Alex Walker is there, the redshirt freshman from Augusta, Georgia, to make the stop. Next week, you like it? There's a kid playing for Maryland.
Well, that's Austin.
Austin, yeah. Walker, who's the plan next week, maybe.
Yeah.
Redshirt freshman. And then there's he is the son of my team member, Doc Walker. Might see him next week, might not. Third down,
you
six.
Never know.
You never know. Lee, pass complete. Aubrey Bell with 38 seconds, and he gets out of bounds and stops the clock. Coming up next week, it's an Atlantic Division battle and a key one. Next Saturday from Death Valley on many of these Raycom sports stations, the Terps of Maryland invade the Clemson Tigers at Death Valley, the pageantry at Clemson second to none, C.J. Spiller, and the run down the hill for the Maryland Terrapins with Darrell Scott, leading rusher among the ACC, and he'll be on the field. And we hope you'll be with us at 12 noon from Death Valley, Maryland at Clemson, from Raycom Sports, our ACC game of the week. First down, 35 seconds left to go for Mississippi State. Looking to get another score here. They pass it complete to Jamail Smith. And he's got it inside the 10 down to the 8-yard line. It'll be a gain of 23.
You know when you're going to go up? Most cases, you're going to get hit. So you might as well hold on. That's a good job.
First and goal from the 8. Now downing the ball is Tyson Lee. Mississippi State is out of timeouts. And they're trying to play it out to the finish and get themselves something to build upon in what probably for Sylvester Krum will be an impossible situation next week, or nearly so, at LSU.
Well, you got to shock the world. And now you just want your kids to think, suppose we were trying to score for the win. You want them to think that, keep that mindset going.
26 seconds left to play. But today this team just might have found out how difficult and how big an accomplishment last year was. Because they aren't, in Sylvester Krum's own estimation, not playing with the same type of urgency that they played last year. Wade Bonner is the receiver, caught it at the 1. And here's what they did today. 391 yards, but they did not score. 288.3 is their average. But that means really nothing.
No, it does. That's irrelevant. What you have now is your seniors have got to get together and have a meeting and decide what kind of season they want to have.
You had 381 yards and you get spanked 38-7. Here's Lee, pass over the middle. And it is incomplete. Oh. No more. Three guys in Georgia Tech. It was intended for Nelson Hurst, but he wasn't even looking back at it. But Tyson Lee had to unload it there very quickly. And let's see how many.
Off his back.
Of his tight end, not even, wasn't aware of it.
Yeah.
That he was the hot read, if in fact that's the case. And boy, had Georgia Tech pull that off.
All right, fourth and goal. Lee surprised by the snap.
Got to it.
And he's not going to be surprised. Then he just lets the football go.
He'll do that.
No. And that shows a lack of concentration for Mississippi State. As Matt Brayman comes up with a loose ball, Georgia Tech will take the ball over on downs anyway, and they'll just down it, and we'll be done.
Boy, that snap got good. The kid's a good athlete.
Yeah.
Gets away from something, but the relentless pursuit of the Yellow Jackets, and it's pretty much indicative of the game.
Yep, fitting into the day here. And, Sylvester Kroon talking it over with Tyson Lee, saying that's not how that play's supposed to end. So we'll down it here, or will we? That'll just hand it off, and that'll do it. Pop will run to its conclusion, and Georgia Tech will complete its domination of Mississippi State. Final score for Paul Johnson's Yellow Jackets. It's a big day. They pick up their third win of the season with a 38-7 conquest of Mississippi State. Behind 500 yards total offense, the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets pick up their third win of the season as they defeat the Mississippi State Bulldogs 38-7. Back with a final word from Atlanta after this word from your local ACC stations. Terrapins and the Clemson Tigers. Final score here in Atlanta. The Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets conquer the Mississippi State Bulldogs in an ACC-SEC clash today, 38-7. Thanks to our great crew here in the booth, our staff, Paul Krause, Chris Byrne, our stage manager, our spotter, Ginger Littlejohn, and in the truck, of course, our producer, Dave Barringer, and our director, Roy Alpers. A great win for the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets to go 3-1 for Mike Hogwood and Rick Dock. Walker, I'm Steve Martin, reminding you that you've been watching exclusive coverage of Atlantic Coast Conference football from Raycom Sports. Paul Johnson and the Yellow Jackets win big in Atlanta.